Ladies and gentlemen, we're live broadcasting worldwide on this Friday, the 9th day of September, 2016. And of course, we will also be here this Sunday, live, on the 15th anniversary of the September 11th attacks. So thank you so much for joining us today. We only have one guest lined up, and that's going to be Rob Dew popping in at the bottom of the third hour. And we have David Knight hosting the fourth hour of Overdrive today. Hillary is in free fall. Hillary is crashing and burning. It is now evident and apparent that they have had a bunch of basically fake polls out there with fake data that they've been entering into them. And the establishment realizes that Hillary is in very, very serious trouble. And so they are panicking right now, trying to figure out what to do. Because all they care about is getting her into office so they can get their next puppet in, Mr. Kane, to cover up for all the previous crimes that the globalists have committed and to continue the ongoing corporate hostile takeover of this republic. But because globalism has been exposed all across the world, it is in basic retreat right now. And opposition is only mounting. The problem is they are brazenly only intensifying their operations despite being defeated. And I call this the Hitler effect, where Hitler didn't give up, as everyone knows, until he was pinned down in Berlin in that bunker. They have hundreds and hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. I mean, I can't even keep track of them. Hundreds. You can just put in Alex Jones, Hillary Clinton, and you'll get hundreds of articles a day just spewing the most incredible, twisted disinformation you can imagine. And they just keep panicking. And I'm only keeping track of the ones attacking me. But it's Julian Assange, Alex Jones, Matt Drudge, Vladimir Putin, Donald Trump triangle of conspiracy. Really is ridiculous to see all this going on. The whole world is against the Bushes and the Clintons. The whole world knows America's been hijacked by criminals. The whole world is sick and tired of watching our government finance and fund Al-Qaeda and ISIS and all these other criminal groups. The whole world knows that America is in the hands of very, very wicked, evil people. And the other side thinks they can just spew talking points and rhetoric and call us evil and call us bad. When the facts are Alex Jones isn't running the country, Matt Drudge isn't running the country, and Donald Trump isn't running the country yet. And boy, even if he gets into office, the opposition he's going to face is going to be enormous. But it's all a signpost showing that we're trying to turn the ship around from certain doom. So this is the animating contest of liberty. We're going to come back and just get into all of it. One of our reporters, auxiliary reporters, have been doing reporting for us off and on for years, got footage of Hillary not being able to come out of a medical tent and having this gurney, the stretcher with emergency personnel in body armor with ambulances and the rest of it. And we started covering this a few days ago, but we missed the forest for the trees. So there's an even bigger story in it. Stay with us. Ladies and gentlemen, it is the 9th day of September 2016 on this Friday global broadcast. I'm your host, Alex Jones, and you need to get strapped in. Turns out that our particular paradigm analysis of the globalists is super on target, but only to one level. We're now getting deeper into the rabbit hole and now getting new approximations of the New World Order operation. And let me tell you, it gets crazier by the minute. These people are lunatics. But they got a plan. And if we know the plan and we educate the public that the plan is anti-human, humanity will do the rest. It may look like globalism is unstoppable. The technocracy is undefeatable. Their system is all going into place. But the minute humanity turns against it and rejects it, there's 7.5 billion of us, we will revolutionize the world overnight. Because the best laid plans of mice and men often go astray. And the globalists' biggest fault in their operations is that they do not promote the best and the brightest, even in their own guild now. They do it via seniority, like it's North Korea or something. And that's why North Korea supplies us with an endless stream of very, very wicked satire, very, very twisted satire, because it is so disconnected. They can't manufacture an automobile. They can't basically invent any technology. They have nothing. And they have a toddling third-generation hereditary dictator who executes members of his family if during 18-hour government events they look like they nod off for 30 seconds. What a wonderful world to live in. North Korea bans sarcasm because Kim Jong-un fears people only agree with him ironically. So schizophrenic, so mentally ill. You can just document Kim. I can show TV viewers this article. It's out of the London Independent. And it's the generals all running around worshiping him like he's a god. Talk about total fruitcake delusional behavior. I mean, it's a joke. But that's big government for you. That's hereditary power for you. That's passing the reins on to your minions. And that's what we see with Hillary Clinton. The same stumbling around, the same sycophantic behavior, the same worship behavior from her aides. She is emblematic of this rotting facade preparing to collapse in on itself. Now, let's talk about that rotting facade. Donald Trump has come out and said, quote, Hillary Clinton is running a global criminal enterprise and spreading terrorism. True words about Hillary Clinton have never been said. She does run a large global criminal enterprise. She is the progenitor or the fount, the fountainhead, the source. With George Soros and a few others, they're the top captains. We're not quite sure who the head general is, but we know who runs the show. They brag about it. We don't know who the king of the ring wraiths are, but we know who they are. And she thinks we're so stupid that she's been arming and running Al-Qaeda and ISIS for at least 6 years, 7 years now, starting with the situation we saw in Libya and now obviously in Syria and 20-something other countries. This is an alliance the globalists have with the Saudi Arabians to spread their brand of Islam. By the way, their brand of Islam is winning. 80% of the world are Sunnis, and the Wahhabist sect out of Saudi Arabia that controls Mecca is now basically enforcing that. And we're seeing more persecution of Sunnis at the hands of Sunnis than probably anybody else. It is a nightmare scenario. A nightmare scenario on so many fronts. We're going to be getting to that clip coming up, but Hillary running global criminal enterprise and spreading terrorism. GOP nominee says he would prevent a 9/11. Yeah, it wouldn't have been hard to do. They were ordered to stand down. Bare minimum, that's been declassified. Continuing, getting into her health. This is from the Association of American Physicians and Surgeons. That's the second largest group in the country. Hillary's health concerns serious, say most doctors polled by the Association of American Physicians and Surgeons. 71% of doctors say Hillary's health concerns are real, serious, and could be disqualifying. Yeah, Dr. Drew, he wasn't anti-Hillary. He just got asked about it on a radio show. Also had a CNN show for 5-6 years. Got canceled a week after he said just the drugs she's taking in the medical records she released. It's just crazy. I mean, I want to talk to her doctors. I want to talk to her. This is dangerous. Well, how dare you say, as a talk show host and as a board certified board examining on a board of examiners, a doctor's doctor who has expertise in this very field, a leading expert. How dare you on a radio show in America talk about the witch king, Hillary Clinton? You just do not do it. I mean, again, that's the press climate in this country, people. And that's why there were hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. I mean, I can't count them all up. I typed in Alex Jones, Hillary Clinton earpiece, and there were over 1,000 articles that popped up. I just looked at 10 or so this morning, and they had the Chicago Tribune saying that I'm this wicked, evil, dark, horrible devil, and that I'm just so horrible, and that I must be stopped, and how dare Donald Trump Jr. tweet out our story, and how evil Matt Drudge is, and blah, 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 and how could we question her? This is just the most outrageous thing ever. And I'm just picking this article because it was just one of the ones I looked at, because it's all nothing but talking points they've put out, regurgitated by this guy. And it sounds like a desperate 9-year-old wrote it. So I'm going to ask Rex, whatever his name is, we'll put it back on screen, to come on the broadcast, Rex Humpke. I love it. Important thoughts from my fingers. Yeah, I guess your fingers don't have a lot of brain cells in them, buddy, because you read this and it's just total panic saying, normal people don't listen to Alex Jones. It's dangerous. Don't listen. He's bad. Oh, my God. This is insane. What's going on? When all we said was, is she wearing an earpiece? It looks like she's wearing an earpiece. There have been big controversies before about earpieces. George W. was clearly wearing one in some of the debates. We covered it then. This woman's a known liar. She's been caught lying over and over again. She's been involved in so many scams, it's a joke. She was representing the Chinese president secretly for money. That's in the new WikiLeaks. A true liberal, Julian Assange, that exposed Bush and the globalists, the neocons, says Hillary is far worse and, quote, a demon. And is creating a demon climate to persecute the press and, quote, put all of our necks in a noose. That's because he's got tens of thousands of pages more he's releasing next week. And tens of thousands after that. So much stuff, it'll make your head spin of the horrible things she's doing. And as a real liberal, he is exposing her. I even saw clips of Ed Schultz basically coming out against Hillary now and saying she's a criminal. So this whole thing is imploding. This whole thing is imploding fast. So running back through these, you've got 71% of one of the biggest medical associations in the country being polled. We have 100% being polled, but then 71% of those polled saying that Hillary Clinton has serious health problems, obviously, on its face. Now, they can call me a conspiracy theorist and say I'm evil all day and the rest of it, but the truth is WikiLeaks has her trying to get Parkinson's medication. And then WikiLeaks has Uma Abedin saying, oh, did you forget your earpiece? Do I need to bring it? So, might have been a hearing aid. Looks like a hearing aid to me. The point is that they put out a few shots with her ear in shadow, photos in Newsweek, you name it. I mean, when I say hundreds, it's probably thousands of articles. I mean, you just can't keep track of them. It says thousands. And saying, oh, we're debunked. Oh, this and that. No, you're debunked. We asked a question about a known liar. James Woods asked the question. We simply picked it up and gave people an opportunity to look at it. It became the number one story yesterday, thanks to DrudgeReport.com and the listeners of the show and others spreading it. And so then they attempt to act like there's no problem. Well, let me tell you, we have what I would call just the added gravy to all of this. Because you add all of this together with this new story I've got when we come back after break. That is from our own reporter in Ohio. Breaking down the fact that they have these ambulances when Hillary is traveling around and that Hillary couldn't come out of a tent and spoke basically 45 minutes late. She's in the tent. They've got an ambulance. They've got people running around with stretchers into the tent where she is, the air-conditioned tent. They've got body armor on. It's Secret Service with EMS outfits on. And they're going into the tent. And this should be investigated massively. I mean, they got a guy running around behind Hillary with an injector pen. Whenever she gets asked questions, she freaks out. And the guy goes, it's okay, keep talking. And people are going, oh, it's preposterous that Hillary would need an earpiece. She's her own woman. Why, she, you know, She used to be really smart. The woman is a bumbling moron now half the time. She's obviously breaking down. She looks completely drugged out and insane. And now they're running around with her in tents with huge medical gurneys with guys in body armor. What in the world is going on here? This needs to be looked at. This is a big story with video on InfoWars.com. All right, my friends, I want to show you a headline before I get back into all the huge election news, Hillary crashing and burning information. There's just so much today to go over, so many important clips. I want to just take you back to an article out of the UK Sun just 2 days ago that I read the headline of, but never even covered. And it's over a 20-page article with all these top scientists, all these top historians, sociologists, psychologists, military experts. By the way, our Pentagon concurs with these reports, saying the planet is closer to catastrophic World War III than at any time for 60 years, experts warn. And it doesn't look good for Britain or America if it does kick off. And this is a big, detailed report. It's excellent. That I want to go over and probably shoot a special report next week on and get some of these guests on just to look at all the trigger points and, you know, the things that are expanding and happening around the planet. Because, you know, we do our research here, but it's good to see it in a big, detailed report like this. And some people will say, well, we haven't had a nuclear war yet, so what's the problem? Well, the problem is it's like having, say, a 65-year-old building. That's how long we've had, you know, the modern atomic age. And we haven't had a big fire yet. Well, statistics show the longer the building's there, the better a chance it's going to end up having a fire. Just because of time going by. And statistically, there's a better chance over a long period of time. Let's say there's an oak tree that's 300 years old. Does it have a better chance or a worse chance of being struck by lightning? In the aggregate, it has a better chance of being struck by lightning the older it is because it's more time. Same thing. And you look at all this, the world is getting more dangerous, not less dangerous. And it's frustrating to me, very, 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 very frustrating to me to sit here and to see this happening and to really be concerned about my family and to see so many Americans and so many other people that just don't have any concern and think nuclear war is a conspiracy theory. The truth is we've already had nuclear wars. Depleted uranium was used in the first Gulf War and the second Gulf War, and now it's being used all over the world, and it is radioactive, and inside the body, it goes into the cells at point-blank range, and even though it's low-level radiation, it cooks them at point-blank range. And cancers have exploded in the troops, the deformities. It's well-documented. I don't need to go into that. Everybody knows that. And now we've got 440-something power-producing nuclear reactors and hundreds, several hundred other research reactors. I mean, I go to the Department of Energy's own website, and you can also go to the International Atomic Energy Agency website, and it doesn't even list two nuclear reactors that are in Austin. So when I say there's 700 reactors, that's not counting submarines, add 300, 400 more onto that, who knows how many reactors? 1,000? 2,000? Who knows? And here's the difference. They're supposed to shut these plants down after 30, 40 years. They're not shutting them down, and they just don't even seem to care now. They're turning the alarms off all over the country so that when they leak radiation by law, the alarms would go off. Well, that scares the public. So now they just turn the alarms off. So bottom line, September is preparedness month. Everybody needs to get prepared. That way it's a win-win if bad things don't happen and there isn't an economic crisis or there aren't larger wars or whatever. Hey, you got insurance you can eat, high-quality, storable foods. You're drinking water through great water purification systems already. Not just for a disaster, but just for the ongoing glyphosates and all the rest of the trash. We've got specials, the biggest we've ever run. 30 to 40% off on storable food, super high quality, totally fresh, last 25 years, InfoWarsStore.com. 30 to 40% off depending on which package you get. Also, big discounts, 20% on water filtration systems. We've got the huge spectrum of non-GMO heirloom open pollinated seeds. We've got so many other great products like Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine, X2, 20% off, and it's going to end early next week. I can't keep extending the sale. I haven't even extended it yet. It's supposed to end Sunday. I might extend it a couple days, but that's it. And by the way, I'm ending next Monday the Hillary for Prison shirts at cost, just because I wasn't thinking when I did that. There's actually more expense in there because the bumper stickers and citizen rule books we add in. I'm actually losing money on it. I just can't do that. We have to fund the operations. I want to thank you all for your support. But if you want a Hillary for Prison shirt for $9.95 with a pocket constitution and two Hillary for Prison shirts, that's shipping included at cost. Get it now at InfoWarsStore.com, InfoWarsLife.com for the supplements, or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Stay with us. You know, I'm going to finish up with World War III news and then get back into the huge Hillary medical news. I mean, when I say huge, I saw this footage on, like, Tuesday that Millie Weaver put out with her camera crew for InfoWars. And I saw the ambulance. I thought, yeah, Trump doesn't have ambulances. And they had all these articles attacking us. Oh, we're kooks. There's always ambulances. And I'm just like, no, that's not true. But, you know, Dick Cheney had ambulances too. Let's just be honest. She's got serious health problems. It's in the WikiLeaks. It's all over the place. The majority of doctors that are polled by prestigious organizations say clearly something's wrong with her. And then in Cleveland, Ohio, hiding in plain view in all this video, is the fact that she didn't come out of the tent for 45 minutes or longer. There's an 18-minute video report showing all this on InfoWars.com. Chick Hillary Clinton has a rolling hospital bed backstage at rally. And see, our headline isn't even strong enough. Hillary didn't come out till 45 minutes later. Hillary was in a hospital tent for 45 minutes, and they rolled a gurney in with guys in body armor. That's your headline. What the hell is going on here? And I have a wonderful crew. They're fantastic. But 9 times out of 10, they make the same mistake I make. They don't go with a sensational enough headline. It's like, okay, ambulances, medical crews, follow Hillary. No, she's in a medical tent for 45 minutes, and they're running around all freaked out like, you know, the emperor just died, rolling in these huge medical gurney, guys in body armor. She's stumbling around. There's a guy with an EpiPen behind her. A tranquilizer pen, telling her it's all right. She's doddering around. She says she wants Parkinson's medication in her own emails. Uma Abedin says, do you need your earpiece? You know, in the WikiLeaks, when she has what looks like an earpiece hanging out her ear, and the media acts like it's kooky that we say that. You guys are discredited. You have a 6% trust rate. Our audience knows that we're going to tell the truth or die trying. Does that mean we don't make mistakes sometimes? Absolutely we do. And we correct them when we do. Because our integrity is our number one possession. But we didn't say she had an earpiece. We said it looks like she has an earpiece. George W. clearly had one. No doubt there. And people said, oh, well, she's a powerful woman. You're saying a woman can't, you know, answer all these complex questions without an earpiece? I'm saying Hillary has a handler running around with a needle standing. A guy has a needle standing right beside her at all times. She's stumbling around. She acts completely insane. And the word is she's having epileptic seizures on a routine basis. Look, I digress. Let's get to the real meat and potatoes here, okay? Earlier this week, I mentioned an article, but never got to it. It's depending on how you format it, 16 to 22 pages long. It's got a lot of graphics, a lot of different generals, military experts, statisticians, the UN's own admission, the Pentagon's own admission, NATO's own admission, the Ministry of Defense's own admission out of the UK, saying everything I'm telling you, because everything I'm telling you is already documented from them and my own historical research. It's not like, wow, everything Alex says just keeps being dead on. How'd he guess it? I didn't guess it. In 2007, the Pentagon came out, and in 2007, so did the Ministry of Defense, and said, by 2016, we will begin the global collapse through 2025. The chances of nuclear war will be the highest ever. There'll be global famines, third world populations surging over the borders, absolute, you know, world government. I mean, go read those reports. We've covered them ad nauseum. So we get up here and we say, hey, governments and institutions are digging in. We better be concerned. We're hoping this isn't the case. I mean, my goodness, I certainly don't want all this stuff to happen. But there's this delusional name it and claim it type culture beyond fake Christians or manipulated Christians, where it's just trendies and everybody just thinks if you hope, everything will be okay. And yes, a lot of confidence in the currency, in the economy is needed. And I'm all for confidence in the economy if it's warranted. But the globalists are doing everything they can to hurt the economy in the real world while telling us it's all great as they consolidate control. And I'm not going to go along with that lie. So you have this headline, planet closer to catastrophic World War III than any other time for 60 years, experts warn, and it doesn't look good for Britain or America if it does kick off. Now, there are rules of war in history, going back to the days of chivalry and before that, where you don't target men, women, and children. That's what Attila the Hun does. That's what the Mongols do. That's what the barbarians do. You don't target women and children. You target fighting soldiers. And then all is fair in love and war. And even in modern American unwritten jurisprudence, you don't target people's families for political assassination, and you don't even target families, wives, daughters, sons, if they're not politically involved. You don't go after people that are not in the arena. And there's a good reason for that. You start going after people's families, gloves come off real fast, and the veneer of civilization peels away like tiles on the bottom of a spacecraft coming in through the atmosphere, plunging into the ocean. But I have seen vitriol by former U.S. generals and by current NATO commanders, including the commander of NATO, and I have seen statements by former CIA directors and others that is the stuff of third world dictator stuff. In fact, it's just not done in history to shoot your mouth off about how you kill people and you're powerful and you're good at killing people. And I came, we saw, he died. Obama, Hillary, they've all said the same amateur stuff. I mean, even when you've killed people with your bare hands, you don't talk about it, you don't brag about it, you don't get into it because it's bad luck. It's stupid. And it's really degrading to yourself and everybody else. So it's a bellwether of a society in collapse. And it's about the most unlucky thing in history soldiers and generals should be involved in. You add to that a bunch of women in fancy $3,000, $4,000 suits with $100,000 diamond rings on and $100,000 necklaces. I mean, sexually getting excited, prancing around up there and in back of the podium talking about, we're going to bloody the Russians' noses. We're going to do this. We're going to do that. Yeah, we sent $5 billion in to overthrow Ukraine. What are you going to do about it? I mean, this is the stuff of nightmares, okay? I mean, this is what defeat is made of. And it just gets crazier from there. So in the last year, we have seen the head of all Russian intelligence agencies just die. They won't even say why he died. He just died at 56 years old. We can put that up on screen. We've seen a bunch of other Russians getting killed. There's a Jerusalem Post. Russia's military intelligence chief killed in secret operation in Lebanon. That's how they spun it. That's not the case. Now, let's expand on all this. This is war when this type of stuff is going on. Now we have Vladimir Putin's favorite chauffeur killed in accident, exactly as former CIA director described on TV on Charlie Rose, where the elite go to communicate with each other. That's the most elite TV program there is, period, is Charlie Rose. And by the way, Charlie Rose on a wickedness scale, on an aristocrat scale, when I ran into him, I mean, it was definitely a very serious presence. He saw me, his eyebrows flared. It was, I like your style, Alex. Ah, his minions were all freaking out. This guy goes to Bilderberg, you name it. I mean, he is a piece of work. But that's where these guys go on these shows. Mike Morrell, former deputy director of the CIA, salivates over the idea of covertly killing Russians and Iranians. The full conversation aired on PBS on August 8th. August 8th. And then, boom, exactly what this guy's talking about is going on. So this happens a month ago, and then a few weeks later, boom, the magic crash. One of their favorite ways to kill somebody is to have, obviously, a stunt driver slam into somebody and take them out. Or they kill you, put you in a car, and then hit you with a truck. I've actually been told by security analysts and folks that we've had to do security checks and sweeps. We had to go to that level. Not that I'm even scared of them taking me out, but I'm not going to make it easy. And I want it documented, too. So we've got a lot of counter-surveillance. These people freak out when we actually send people to their house. You know, it's like, oh, you're going to come to my house? Well, then when you go to your house in another state, we're going to drop by too. See, that's how that works. But this is how they take you out. I've been told this is the number one way to watch my ass at four-way stops, at red lights, you name it. They'll just slam into me with a truck. Boom. And this is how they get you. So he called for killing, quote, everyone around Putin because they had trouble getting to Putin. Kill everyone around Putin. And I can play all the clips of generals saying it's time to start killing Russians, kill a lot of them, body bags, blood, blood, blood. Oh, yeah, let's kill Russians on their border. What a wonderful idea. Russia has the GDP of Italy. Russia's trying to rebuild. China is the one taking the whole planet over right now. And the globalists are double-crossing Russia. They are trying to bring Russia down. I mean, because they see Russia as weak. That's what's happening. And then they blame Russia for everything going on in the world. If you oppose the globalists, the multinationals that have captured our country, captured Europe, captured the UK, they're trying to get out of it. They say, oh, Nigel Farage, you work for Putin. That's why Nigel Farage, a successful businessman, 25 years ago saw the EU taking over the regulations of control in the UK, and he looked at veterans memorials of all these people that had died, including people in his family, a lot of military people in his family, and he got pissed off. 25 years ago, before Vladimir Putin was on the radar screen, he stood up for the UK's sovereignty. And you take that away from him and the people of the UK, the people of England, and you say, Russian agents. The only Russian agent business going on here is that Russia has been captured by the very same globalists and has gone through the exact same crap, but decades ago, we're starting to go through here. So they've already been raped by the same guy now raping us. And Russia's like crawled away into the shadows, finally throwing the rapist off and is trying to nurse its wounds while we're getting raped. And the person raping us, economically, culturally, you name it, is telling us, by the way, while I'm raping you, go over there and kick Russia's ass. That's what's going on. And the whole world's saying, no, thank you. Donald Trump's going, what's Russia doing to us? China. That's what all the generals are telling him. Because that's what's happening. Hillary is a Chinese agent. We're a joke, people. We've been totally taken over by foreign countries, foreign interests, just like Russia was taken over by the oligarchs. We could have such an amazing time of detente. And business and ingenuity and rebuilding the planet together if we get the globalists off our backs. And we're so close, people. But the churches have all been paid, all the big ones, to say it's the end of the world and you can't beat evil. So you just believe, you lay down and sit there at your little church with your little candy-ass preacher up there who's a damn demon. Oh, I mean, there's no one more evil than the preachers that know full well what's going on. They're there with their little Homeland Security badges, brainwashing people. We have state-run churches now in this country. It's time to end all this. It's time to break its back. It's time to stop it. And so this is all part of what inches us towards World War III, is they're saying, let's start killing Russian leaders, and then the Russians start dying. And then we say, oh, did they kill the Russian head of security? Intelligence, oh, did they kill his chauffeur. Did they kill this person? Did they kill that person? And they go, oh, you're a conspiracy theorist. It doesn't work anymore. Let's go to this clip from Charlie Rose.
I give them the things that they need to both go after the Assad government, but also to have the Iranians and the Russians pay a little price, right? When we were in Iraq, the Iranians were giving weapons to the Shia militia who were killing American soldiers, right? The Iranians were making us pay a price. We need to make the Iranians pay a price in Syria. We need to make the Russians pay a price. The other thing I would do...
We make them pay the price by killing Russians?
Yes.
And Iranians. Killing Iranians?
Yes. Covertly. So you don't tell the world about it, right? You don't stand up at the Pentagon and say, we did this, right? But you make sure they know it in Moscow and Tehran. Here's the other thing I want to do. I want to go after... those things that Assad sees as... his personal power base, right? I want to scare Assad. So I want to go after his presidential guard. I want to bomb his offices in the middle of the night.
Well, that happened about 2 years ago, as you remember.
Back it up. I could talk for 5,000 hours on this guy. The Ivy League slime, a wimp, talking about scaring people. Sliming around. This is the guy that came out against Donald Trump for Hillary. A joke. Someone Trump said, I don't trust, I wouldn't want to talk to. The generals tell me he's horrible. You just look at somebody like General Flynn compared to somebody like this little turd blossom, and it's honorable. Skip the break. This is too important. Thank you. Honorable, strong, a good record, patriotic, help smash ISIS and Al-Qaeda, countermanded the CIA, got kicked out over it. They don't want to arrest him, though, because that soft coup will expose them. There was a soft coup in this country, led informationally by InfoWars. And by the way, I don't say that to sound big. The enemy already knows it. You should know it, okay? You should know it. We led the attack 4+ years ago. And we had the experts on, from Dr. Steve Pachinik to Colonel Schaefer to Tosh Plumlee to countless others. And they gave you the intel on the whole plan. And they even said they're going to flood Europe next with refugees before ISIS ever existed. Because we have patriots, by and large, that work in our government. And now we sit here with this guy up there going, we need to bomb the presidential guard, bomb their government buildings. That's what ISIS does. That's what Al-Qaeda does. Same group. And they went and started it with Assad, that was bringing the West in, that was transferring power, that was democratizing, just like Muammar Gaddafi. They all believed Obama. Assad and Gaddafi believed him. That it was detente. Oh, I'm liberal. Here, take my hand. Yes, let us invest. Bring your money in. And they went, okay, we don't want to fight. Now, you could say Gaddafi fought back and done some things that weren't good from the West perspective, but Assad had done nothing. Medical doctor brought up in the UK. And they brought in Al-Qaeda, and they killed over 200,000 Christians we know of. And the numbers just grow. Syria was 24% 6 years ago Christian. It's now like 10% or so. Millions have left as refugees, God knows where, because the West won't take Christians. Hundreds of thousands are dead. And they bring in 0.3 refugees into Europe and the U.S. Same number as a sick joke. You got 20-something percent that were Christian, but 0.3 get in. They let in less than 1% Shiites. They're almost all Wahhabists. And you sit back and you're looking at the former CIA deputy director, the one of the main architects of this, and he sits there talking about, we want to scare people. Oh, like Hitler did, bombing civilian targets in London? The British didn't even want to be in that war? British knew that they'd started World War I and it was wrong. As soon as Hitler started bombing civilian targets, they totally turned against him. And had almost 100% support, total mobilization. That's where you people are blind. You live in a world of fear. They're always threatening me, like, oh, you threaten me. I'm going to shut up now. You mean you kill people? Oh, my gosh. I didn't know. I hadn't been told thousands of times. I hadn't been physically attacked. I hadn't been drugged to the mud. I hadn't been assaulted. I hadn't had all sorts of intelligence agencies jack with me. But it's pretty much silent now. It's like, went over to the other side. Escaped out of your little phony fairy tale. You guys know, short of Davy Jones's locker, I'm never stopping. But you notice, he sits there and he goes, he's so slimy, we need to scare them. We need to kill the people around them. We need to kill their families. Just the slimiest crap on earth. It's just the venomous. And of course, it's this little soft pseudo-intellectual, and they all get the think tanks together and all glad hand each other and slap each other's on, you know, on their butts and everything, and go play golf together and suck off all the stolen money and just pull all this crap. You're not Americans. You hijacked this country, and America's never been perfect. But America, in the final equation, is not going to put up with your New World Order trash, your bullying garbage, and the fact that the people running the country have never fought for it, never done anything, and are a bunch of weak cowards. You're not leaders. You're deceptive filth. And you sit there and you spew lies to the public, the likes of which I've never seen. The globalists took down Syria. The New World Order, George Soros, Obama, Hillary, are the architects of it, the creators of the new Al-Qaeda base in Libya, to get all those weapons and to ship them in to the next country. Classic communist tactic. Take over one country, exploit it onto the next group. It's so crazy to watch Goldman Sachs and all these big banks and all these arrogant, sociopathic, disconnected, rich globalists with their yachts and their helicopters and all their crap destabilizing the world so they get total control, but now realizing they're in such danger, they're doubling their security details and, again, building armored fortresses in the middle of the South Pacific. Oh, what a great plan you did, yet again. Wonderful. You convinced yourself of your own bull. And now you're killing people in Russia. And you're bragging about it. I can play the generals on Fox News like it's tough. It's just time to start killing a bunch of Russians in Ukraine. That'll teach them. Yeah, that'll really teach them, and just start killing people. This isn't the Iraqis. And I love how he sits there and implies, oh, we had to go to Iraq and the Iranians did stuff to us in Iraq. What? We blamed Iraq for what Saudi Arabia was involved in. That was all part of the Wahhabist plan. Wahhabists carry it out. Wahhabist enemy gets blamed. It's all lies. Sitting there like a little snake, spewing this BS, hoping the viewers don't know who the players are. And hey, Sally Soccer Mom might not know. Billy Bob Dumbass may not know. You know all the military knows. They know who the players are. They know how the cow ate the cabbage, Dumbo. And I don't think you're going to have the robots in place and the troops spiked in time. Because we didn't just sit here on our butts while little Ivy League tough guys like you ran around trying to scare people. You didn't scare us. You mobilized us. The whole world, dumbass. And you're going to be held accountable. Make no mistake. Now, I need this operation energized to the next level. I need you to spread the word, the articles, the videos, all up to the four corners of the planet every hour. I need you to pray for us and set your will against the globalists and set your will in support of InfoWars. I pray to God. And to take advantage of the massive sales we've got going on preparedness items. In case we lose the first phase of this, we've got to be prepared to dig in. Stay with us. I knew what this Chicago Tribune writer would do before I never sent the email an hour ago. I knew what he'd do. And my feelings aren't hurt that he dissed us because he's so powerful. I'm sad because I knew that this random individual who I picked this morning to illustrate something to the viewers and listeners would be this little cowardly slime ball that I thought he was. I've had more than 20 major publications just in the last month or so want to do major profiles and come down here to Austin, Texas. And I've told them, no, I'm not doing it. Go make up whatever you want. I know you just want to interview me so that you can then act like you were actually a journalist and act like there's credibility to what you did. You're trying to write a roadmap to attack Alex Jones. I've been down this road. I don't care. I'm in hundreds of articles a day, thousands a week. What do I care about you, okay? Now, I said, if you want to do a live debate on air with me, I mean, I was thinking about getting like the London Guardian, the New York Times, and the New Yorker Magazine, everybody else here, and have them just all right here debating me live on air. That could be their interview. And they said, no, 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 we want to go to dinner with you, and we want access to your family. Oh, yeah, I've heard it all before. Good luck. That said, though, you get these little egomaniacs that nobody knows who they are, like this Rex Cupcake guy. And I just saw, literally, said Google said there were thousands of articles today with the name Alex Jones, Hillary Clinton in it. But hundreds and hundreds specifically on the earpiece. And look, James Woods pointed it out, looks like an earpiece. Bush was clearly wearing one. We're saying, is she wearing an earpiece? I mean, this is a known liar, involved in all sorts of stuff. She's got Secret Service people beside her, doctors, you know, saying it's okay when somebody asks a question. She's clearly got mental problems. So he comes out with a column, Trump and the mainstreaming of dark craziness. So I send him an email. I'm going to show TV viewers the email. I say, good morning, Mr. Hupke. And I transcribed this, but I mean, Nico transcribed it, a voice memo, but sent it. Alex read your recent column, Trump and the Mainstreaming of Dark Crazies, and obviously disagrees with your perspective, but he welcomes the criticism, would like to invite you on the show to speak on one-on-one with him about your perception of InfoWars this year's election and anything else on your radar. He picked your column at random out of numerous articles written about him and would like to invite you on to defend your ideas and have a serious discussion with him. Now, what I'm going to start doing is, every day, we're going to pick one of these people. People ask, in fact, it's a criticism. Why don't you have opposition on? Why don't you have people with opposing views? Can't handle it? They will not come on, none of them, because they all just get talking points and regurgitate it over and over and over again. And you read the article he wrote, it's all whatever the PR boss of Hillary wrote weeks ago that she put out in that alt-conservative speech. I mean, it's written like a seventh grader was, you know, talking about some evil monster it saw under the bed or something, okay? And so he comes back with, ha! That's all these narcissists have. Ha! A serious discussion. That's a good one. Ha, 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 ha. Well, you people say whatever you want, dumbass. I do have some thoughts on how the Obama administration used fluoride in my toothpaste to turn me into a mindless lib zombie. Well, I mean, Harvard has 25 studies saying it causes a massive IQ reduction, and the White House science czar wrote a book admitting they put it in the water to lower your IQ. It's called Eco-Science. It's free online. Read it. He goes, but I'm saving that for a more credible outlook. At least all part of being credible. My answer to your question is no, absolutely not. Not ever. Not in my career, depending on it. We're going to come back and finish up with this. Stay with us. But this is the essence of cowardice. By the way, I haven't seen this yet because she attacks me almost every night. But Rachel Maddow reportedly did some big demonization campaign last night against a bunch of the nutraceuticals we sell. And then literally they have nutraceutical and supplement ads on MSNBC, all over Fox, everywhere. I mean, you go to the CVS or anywhere, it's all over the place. And, but it's like bad. Again, this is the Clinton playbook that came out in their foundation documents, not from the current Clinton Foundation, but from their library foundation, that they were saying back in the early 1990s, we can't let any other opposition media ever sell books or newsletters or coffee cups or products or films. They might create an industry. See, they get it. Yes, that's right. funding ourselves with the information warfare, creating a culture, creating a civilization outside of your new dark age. So I'm told that it's just ridiculous. And she sits there for like 10 minutes reading out products and descriptions and things, just flipping out over it. And this is economic warfare. It's why they're trying to do hack attacks to hurt us and trying to get the, you know, FDA in on us and all this other stuff, as if we didn't prepare for that already. I mean, it's just incredible. I mean, she said Breitbart doesn't have a right to exist. She's going to try to shut it down if she gets elected. Right there, anyone in their right mind should vote against Hillary. Julian Assange, super liberal. He says she's, quote, a demon, destroying our freedoms. But I'm very honored to have these type of attacks going on. So as soon as we get those clips together, they were just telling me about them during the break, we'll play some of it. We're going to have the Mr. Maddow special. Just have a little bit of fun, you know, with it all. Because, you know, actually, she's an incredible thespian actor, actress. She plays Chris Hayes, or Chris Hayes plays her. It's actually the same person on air. I'm being sarcastic. That's satire. Maybe not. Sometimes I'm confused. I just love the pinhead act of Chris Hayes, those glasses. Like, he's a little smart. I have this Bob's Big Boy haircut, and I'm going to talk to you like I know everything, and we're really intellectuals. But our followers on the street can't find their butt with both hands. So, continuing, quote, ludicrous. Boom! Hillary, get out the way! Get out the way! Hillary, get out the way! I'm not into vulgarity, but I really want to do a music video with Ludacris and bitch, move out the way, because it really does detail it all. I mean, just get out the way! Get out the way! Go get in your stretcher, have another seizure, whatever it is you do with Uma, and just sail off across the pus-filled ocean of green globules that you so love. And just leave us alone. We don't want to be poor. We don't want to be stupid. We don't want to be controlled by you. We want fast cars. We want guns. We want private property. We want America. Get out the way. Get out the way! Oh. I'll be honest. I don't listen to a lot of hip-hop and rap, but when it's good, it's good. I mean, some of it is totally mindless, just like most rock and roller stuff, but I tell you, there's some good stuff out there. And it just came to me a few months ago. I hadn't heard it in over a decade. That particular Ludacris song, Bitch, Move Out the Way, is the way to go. I mean, it's just, everybody gets it. Move out the way. I mean, I'm going down the highway at least 100. You're doing 50. In fact, it hit me this morning. It hit me this morning. Winston Smith being tortured in the allegory of 1984 by O'Brien at the Ministry of Love, where they torture you to death. Winston says the ability to be free is to be able to say 2 + 2 = 4. And O'Brien goes, you're absolutely damn right it is. By the time we screw your brain up and turn you into a mindless idiot, you won't be able to even have a coherent thought. But it's beyond that. People that drive in the fast lane, the ability to only drive in the fast lane when you're passing is civilization. Because I drive by the people that'll be doing 55 and a 70 in the fast lane with 3-4 lanes of traffic. I'm having to drive in the slow lane because they're in the fast lane, and I look at them and they always look completely blitzed out of their mind. Old white guy, Hispanic lady, black lady, I don't care. And they're just, I mean, they have no idea what planet they're on. And I'm telling you, it's a good third of the drivers are in the fast lane. They think, oh, there's an open lane over there. I'm just going to go drive over into that. I wish the police, and I'm not into giving tickets and stuff, but listen, I want $1,000 fines if you are in the fast lane and you're not passing. I want $1,000 fines. In fact, I want you arrested because you are spiritually getting in the way. Get behind me, Satan. What was that Ludacris song? It's almost a Bible study. I'm not kidding. It's like holy text. Maybe you could like play that song to Rachel Maddow at Camp X-Ray, and she would, after the 50,000th time she heard it, finally get it. We want you to move out the way. Move out the way. Move out the way. You got it? Move out the way. Everything you do is about making us a dumb, stunted, moron, idiot, and I'm tired of it. Excuse me. We're going to make a big initiative out of this. Will any coward face us? Is there any amongst the mainstream media that aren't cowards? Because they sit up there, and it's all about this authority, and they're the anointed ones, and they tell people who can be interviewed and who can be talked to and what is acceptable information, like Gary Johnson telling the town hall reporter, was very polite, excuse me, you don't use the word illegal immigrants, and you use the words I say. And he goes, well, no, it's illegal, and you know, that's what Mexico calls it, too. And, you don't do that. I control reality. No, you don't control reality, Karl Rove or Gary Johnson or Rachel Maddow or this person, Rex Humke, that no one's ever heard of, at the declining, collapsing Chicago Tribune, just like the New York Times, totally bankrupt, owned by the Mexican kingpin. Well, he's actually the Muslim kingpin or whatever he is, a Middle Eastern kingpin, by way of Mexico, that owns the New York Times. And then he writes this article. And again, I just randomly this morning saw a whole bunch of these articles attacking me. They were all basically the same script that goes out. They just then kind of rewrite and regurgitate how evil I am and how no one should listen to me and how horrible it is the Trumps are listening. And, oh, my God, it's horrible. And you better not do that. You know, you better not touch her medical issue. Hillary's warned people. You're being told. And so we sent him an email, and I'm going to start doing this every day. We're going to send emails out to the media, the so-called media, and we're going to say, hey, we disagree with you, but we'd like you to come on, talk about how horrible I am to my own audience. Maybe you can save some of these people. And he said, listen, I go on credible outlets. Oh, my gosh, you're so credible. Wonder how big that paycheck is over there. I probably aren't even paid there at the collapsing Chicago Tribune. But you've got your little ego, probably live with mommy. I'm sure, looking at this Rex Humke guy, probably lives with mommy. I mean, certainly he wasn't raised by a man. Because he only does what Hillary says, what mommy says. He only talks to who mommy says. I mean, the idiot thinks we want him for credibility. No, your own corporate whore media keep saying we only have people on that agree with us. I'm trying constantly behind the scenes to get you cowards on because you're idiots. I want to get you up here and make you look like a fool, and you know that, so you don't come on because you're a keyboard commando. That's why the name of his column is Thoughts from My Fingers. How about Thoughts from Your Butt? And it continues, Trump and the mainstreaming of dark crazies. The same talking point, dark-hearted Alex Jones. I mean, you got anything that's original in your little fop brain? Now, continuing here. Yeah, how discredited am I going to be as it comes out Hillary is sicker and sicker? So that's why this works that way, dum-dum. So he sends us this email back. We're very nice. We said we'd like to have you on. This is just an hour ago. He says, ha! Well, first off, I got laughed at. I'm back in junior high. I'm going to go cry to my mommy. The other kids at the playground laughed at me. Oh, boy. Huh. That's very intellectual. Ha. Huh. A serious discussion? That's a good one. I do have some thoughts on how the Obama administration used fluoride in my toothpaste to turn me into a mindless lib zombie. But I'm saving that for a more credible outlet. Anybody can Google Harvard studies, 25 of them, lowered IQ, brain damage, on and on. I mean, they're pulling fluoride out worldwide. The EPA has said take it out of the water 5 years ago. Hadn't happened yet. But you make little jokes because you can go, ha, ha, with your keyboard. To answer your question, no, absolutely not. No, never. I love how you say it over and over. No, 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 no. To answer your question, no, absolutely not. No, never. Not in my career. Depend on it. Is that like a man? I mean, a woman doesn't even write like that. It's just like, yeah. It goes on. And shame on you for the fear, hatred, and nonsense you sling about for the sake of a con. Again, huh, you're goofy. You're not credible. Oh, shame on you. Just all like, nanny, nanny, boo-boo, stick your head and doo-doo. This is you think he's trained in this. This is who he is. This is a pack follower. He would follow an entire latrine down a drain if he was told to by Hillary. And I'm telling you, I predict we're going to send these out to hundreds of these people And I guarantee you one out of 50 will come on. Because these aren't men. These are followers. And they think attacking me, the dinosaur, collapsing with 6% trust rate, AP reports. You think I am scared that you're saying I'm horrible and evil? This, please continue giving me the blue ribbon at the fair. I mean, these are Oscars. These are Grammys. These are Emmys. More. By the way, I said it was like 8-9 minutes. I'm sorry. It's 13 minutes long, and I'm going to have to play it. I only saw a few minutes of it during the break. It's Mr. Maddow, Ron Maddow, last night on MSNBC, literally just flipping out with my face up there with Putin's and Trump's, like it's the new Mount Rushmore, and like I'm this evil scammer because I point out that there was mainstream news articles saying that if you have a lot of selenium in your body, it's very hard for Zika to replicate. I mean, I live in Texas where Zika has been found. I'm giving it to my kids. We came out with a high-quality organic selenium. There's nothing wrong with that. We're not bad selling vitamins and minerals. But again, what we got to do is actually find clips of the advertisers on MSNBC. You guys got a mic open, that have pretty good sponsors. I mean, they've got some nutraceutical sponsors on Fox that are excellent products. I mean, it's like, what? You're selling serotonin reuptake inhibitors and all these other drugs that admittedly have all these horrible side effects. And then we're doing stuff like, hey, you know, we got BioPQQ that has the equivalent of, you know, 50 cartons of blueberries in every serving. I mean, it's a fact. So this is economic warfare. They think doing this, it's going to somehow hurt us. So we're launching the Rachel Maddow special. No, the Mr. Maddow special. On every product she plugs and attacks, an additional 15% off. Because some of these already have like 20% discounts running through this weekend. We also have high-quality, storable food. Government's hoarding food. Government's digging in. Government's preparing for collapse. We think it's important, hopefully none of this happens, but to have high-quality, storable food. I know I've been increasing the amount I have. I know the rich elites are all moving to armored redoubts and putting in safe rooms, but we're bad. Now food's evil. Maybe they'll pass a law saying, I can't say you need food to live. Or Jones's newest conspiracy theory, you need oxygen to live. That's insane. Next, they'll say carbon dioxide's what plants live off of, too. It's ridiculous. Everyone knows we've got a band of hydrogen monoxide. Water. Meanwhile, I have articles like this in front of me. They're banning George Washington and Thomas Jefferson from high schools, colleges, you name it. I'm going to get to this later. Because they own slaves. And they moved to try to get it banned, but couldn't. So what do you do when this is going on? And I'm not defending the institution, but it wasn't all like roots to understand that. Basically like sharecroppers. Now, you had really trashy, horrible people that didn't, you know, that were doing horrible things. But the point is that there were slaves in the time of Jesus that the Jews had. Do we have to stop teaching the Bible because there was slavery? Slavery was worldwide until 200 years ago. And then England started the process of banning it worldwide. Christian abolitionists. Fact. Evil white devils began the process of banning slavery worldwide. And then evil white devils started running around blowing stuff up and killing people here until they started banning it here. So it's just not fair to blame whites across the board. It's ridiculous. But I'm already digressing. We're dealing with a global organized crime syndicate that has dropped any pretense of being honest. They're going completely insane. And Trump has come out and said in a speech yesterday that Hillary Clinton is running a global criminal enterprise. And that's why they're going for broke. But the biggest news that I only mentioned a little bit last hour is coming up in the next segment. Hillary was in Ohio and had to go into an emergency tent for 45 minutes with stretchers and people running around like a beehive had been hit with a baseball bat. This is big news. What happened in Ohio? Our reporters were there and have the video. It's coming up. But first, here's Donald Trump on the criminal global enterprise of Hillary Rodham Clinton.
The whole country saw how unfit she was at the town hall last night, where she refused to take accountability for her failed policies in the Middle East that have produced millions of refugees, unleashed horror of radical Islamic terrorism all over and made us less safe than ever before. Throughout it all, she put the country, and I mean the entire country, at risk in order to cover up her pay-for-play scandals as Secretary of State. These include scandals giving up uranium to Russia, doing favors for UBS Bank, and selling contracts to friends and family in Haiti. It's all about hiding criminal enterprise, and that's what it's about. As part of her criminal cover-up, Hillary's, and you know her staff, you know it well, you read about it all the time.
We're going to come back and play this full clip because it's historic that he's telling the truth. He's incredibly bold, and what he's saying is all true. And so the criminals in the dying mainstream media are doing everything they can to try to stop the American people from taking their country back. The Russians kicked the oligarchs out. We're going to kick your asses out as well, parasites. Stay with us. We'll be back. All right, these headlines are too insane. I haven't gotten to a lot of these. I want to finish up with this incredible Trump speech, this clip that I cut short, and I want to then get into Rachel Maddow. It's a 13-minute clip. I don't know if I can air the whole thing. We're going to put a blurb up on Infowars.com dealing with it. But, again, it isn't about Rachel Maddow talking about us because she literally is one of the top shows on MSNBC. 500,000 viewers a night? I mean, that's pathetic. Sweetheart, we put out videos every day that get millions of views apiece, just individual videos. This show has upwards of 4 million a day terrestrial rated listeners on radio stations. And that's a small part of our audience. I mean, you're a joke. You are a joke. But you're totally White House run on record. So it's very interesting to just see what you say and how amateurish it all is. It's funny to really see them flounder around like this. We do have a preparedness special running right now, 30 40% off on high-quality storable foods at InfoWarsStore.com. But we've added a lot of new specials. We're adding the Mr. Maddow special. That's actually what it's called. And it is 20% off on Survival Shield X2 because that's ongoing, 15% off Super Male Vitality, 15% off Deep Cleanse. These are the things she all demonized and attacked. Oh, my gosh. We're so ashamed that we went on air and talked about how selenium is good for you. And then they claimed it was tied into articles that were on our site at the same time. Like, that's something bad. Yes, I'm here going, hey, we're selling selenium. Wow, it's in the news about selenium and Zika. Wow, look at this. Yeah, exactly. But see, with them, everything's from a deception point of view. So if something lines up, it's like a deception. No, we've made a big deal that day over the fact that we have an article out about selenium and Zika. Our writers didn't even know we were launching a new product, BioTrue Selenium from mustard seed, needed electrochemically throughout the body. I mean, if you're a Rachel Maddow viewer, okay, a lot of liberals I know are really smart on supplements. Selenium is like the hottest thing for a decade. I mean, it's you don't have electrochemical activity in the body without it. You die without it. And most of the forms that they put in multivitamins and things are synthetic. So, yes, we sell BioTrue Selenium for mustard seed. I'm very proud of that. It's like we're guilty and bad because I sell Hillary for prison shirts at cost. I should sell them for a profit to fund the operation. I mean, General Flynn says, yeah, lock her up in prison. That was chanted at the RNC. It was said by mothers of dead Navy SEALs. I think Hillary should be in prison. And I'm economically and culturally kicking your ass. MSNBC's been bankrupt for years. It's just propped up by the big banks because they don't want to admit their facade has fallen. We're not bankrupt, Dumbo. You try to come in with the FDA and shut down our supplements? Snap my fingers. The listeners will flood us with more money than you ever saw. You can't find your ass with both hands. You don't understand what you're dealing with, and you're a joke and a fake liberal and a pseudo-intellectual, and I'm sick of people like you. You're a joke. How are you going to feel as more and more about your world government comes out and more emails come out and more corruption comes out? You think WikiLeaks doesn't have stuff far worse than it's releasing? That the power structure itself doesn't want out because it's so damaging. You really hitched your wagon to the wrong pony, sweetheart. And again, she's just a symbol, an example, a figurehead, a logo of what we're dealing with here. But they are coming after us on every front, which I'm very, very proud of. But let me just go over some of these headlines for you. George Washington banished by PC police, WorldNet Daily. The president of San Francisco Board of Educators wants Washington and Jefferson banned as school names because the American founders had slaves. And they want colleges to pull the name off of dorms called Lynch. It's an Irish name because there's a word called lynching. This is total war on reality. A history professor rips down campus 9/11 never forget posters. This is the same professor that came out and said that we deserved 9/11 and it happened because we're imperialists. No, the globalists worked with Saudi Arabia to carry this out. And Al-Qaeda is carrying out its own Islamicist garbage. Carrying out its own Islamicist colonialism. Let's continue here. Assange, up to 100,000 pages of Clinton documents come true. Earlier, I was going from memory. I said 10,000 more next week. I have to correct myself. See, I don't really exaggerate. I tend to just somehow dial stuff back. It's 100,000. Let me correct myself from last hour. Pages of Clinton documents to come. That's next week, so get ready for that. But it's okay. We have the video clip up on Infowars.com. Nancy Pelosi on Clinton emails. Let's just move on from this and just forget about it because she's been caught in total lies. And more is coming out. We have this Botoxed, taxidermied, living dead creature worth billions of dollars, worth nothing when she got into office. This bloated creature up there. I mean, give me a break. It's like a Pomeranian. Don't worry, though. Former IMF economist declares war on cash as we must get rid of it to bring in the world government. Dozens of pregnant women have Zika virus amid growing outbreak in Miami. International Business Times. But don't worry. Don't tell women about the international studies that it's basically almost impossible to get Zika if you have high amounts of selenium in your body and that only the deficiency allows the virus to replicate. Don't tell anybody to go to the local drugstore and get selenium. Don't tell anybody the answer. A major mitigator. No. No, no, no. Or Rachel Maddow, who looks anorexic on TV. In person, I'm told she looks like a beanpole. And I'm not trying to talk about how she looks, but it's like, why is it so authoritative if a woman doesn't look like a man and she's got a short, or a woman doesn't look like a woman, she looks like a man. And then it's like the uniform of these arrogant, weird women with big, long giraffe necks and big Adam's apples like they're aliens. And then they just sit there and spew talking points off a teleprompter at us. So I got plenty of intellectual points against Maddow, but I mean, what is it? I mean, what's the issue? What's going on? I mean, I don't care if women like women. I like women. I get it. The point is, I'm a libertarian. The point is like, what is it about these people? Why is she out to get us? I mean, what did we do to her? This is the net. I mean, look at that. I can't even do it. Just like, they just get themselves all. Doesn't matter if we don't have any viewers compared to Alex Jones. We imagine we do, so we're important. Look, the whole world's against you, lady. The whole world's turned against you. You're a joke. Your goddess is a faltering creature spewing up huge green globlets. If your goddess was a reincarnated Marilyn Monroe, I might have to, you know, admit you're going to win. But see, you hate the goddess. That's why you don't ever look like a goddess. You hate women. You want to control women. You want to pimp women. You think strength is imitating the worst men. You are the opposite of a feminist. Let's get that clear, sweetheart. Now, continuing with our coverage here of Chris Hayes, excuse me, Rachel Maddow, let me get into some other news here. Obama pushes lame duck TPP despite uproar over pro-corporate provisions. Syrian rebel who kidnapped and shot journalist twice, now CIA-backed moderate. Of course. And then I've got articles here where the Mexican government wants to renege on the Treaty of Guadalupe Hidalgo that ceded California, Texas, parts of Oregon, New Mexico, you name it, to the United States. Here's a little newsflash. There were six flags over Texas. There were four or five flags over California. The Mexican government couldn't hold it from the natives. And so this claim that this was all Mexico is just stupid. Yeah, Guatemala was Mexico too. Couldn't keep that. How many Americans know the history of Mexico? Almost none. How many Mexicans know it? Almost none. I know it. Probably read 15 books on the subject. Santa Ana was engaged in all these atrocities. Basically brought back slavery. Didn't call it that. The Guatemalans broke away. You know, Mexico used to basically be Central America. Okay, are they claiming Guatemala back for, you know, for Mexico now? They say if Trump gets in, they've introduced a bill to secede from the United States. And people make jokes about that. If we're run by globalists, they'll let them do that. But none of that's going to happen. They're merging our countries. It's so incredibly saddening. And then we have all these other videos here of Mexican nationals in the U.S. calling for the murder of Donald Trump. Don't hold your breath to see if any of that happens. And again, these are just like the general population of the U.S., dumbed down people that really think they're on a holy crusade to stop this evil Donald Trump that really wants to hurt them. When the truth is, the United States is used like a giant latrine by the globalists. Now, Rachel Maddow is coming up, but we probably should play the Mexican guy saying kill everybody. But let's play Trump, because I didn't get to the whole clip, breaking down the criminal enterprise that Hillary runs. And this is the truth. She's been caught. It's worse than we thought. I didn't even imagine she'd be selling access to the Chinese president. That came out last week. I mean, it's just 100,000 pages of stuff. Assange better release it now just to have time in the next 58 days to the election to see what's in there. But here is Donald Trump, who I've gone from tacitly supporting to absolutely supporting. What a statesman. What a man. What stamina. What courage. What bravado. You talk about machismo, he's got it. Here it is.
The whole country saw how unfit she was at the town hall last night, where she refused to take accountability for her failed policies in the Middle East that have produced millions of refugees, unleashed horror of radical Islamic terrorism all over, and made us less safe than ever before. Throughout it all, she put the country, and I mean the entire country, at risk in order to cover up her pay-for-play scandals as Secretary of State. These include scandals giving up uranium to Russia, doing favors for UBS Bank, and selling contracts to friends and family in Haiti. It's all about hiding criminal enterprise, and that's what it's about. As part of her criminal cover-up, Hillary's, and you know her staff, you know it well, you read about it all the time, you just read about it, and it's getting worse and worse. Hillary Clinton's staff deleted and digitally bleached, which is acid cleaned, her emails after receiving a congressional subpoena. That's after receiving, not before. That's after receiving. Then, when she was interviewed by the FBI, she claimed she couldn't remember important events 39 times.
Because of the head injury.
She couldn't even remember whether she was trained or handling classified information.
She said because she was brain dead.
Anything about it. So she really didn't remember. That's a problem. And if she did remember, that's a problem. She even said she didn't know what the letter C stood for, whether it was confidential, classified information.
You know, she's CIA.
Or something. All the while, as Hillary and Bill raked in millions of dollars from special interest, the world was falling apart. Hillary Clinton's policies produced ruin in Libya, Iraq, and Syria. Absolute ruin and death. She failed in Russia. She failed in China. She failed miserably in North Korea. Her policies unleashed ISIS, spread terrorism, and put Iran on a path to nuclear weapons.
That's right.
Not to mention the ransom payments.
We're being set up.
Oh, those ransom payments. Remember 2 weeks ago, it was $400 million in cash.
That's $1.6
billion. Well, yesterday we found out that in cash, it was $1.7 billion.
That's right.
These are unheard of. This is cash. This isn't wire transfer. This isn't check. This is cash, $1.7 billion. And then you say, is that going to terror or is that going to people's bank accounts? I actually think it's going to both.
Of course it is. Trump's so smart. I wish he'd let us know this a decade ago. But he was being a sleeper cell for the Patriots. Amazing. Reality is so much stranger than fiction, as has been said many times. I've got so much more to get into, but people need to understand that when I told you that Mexico's talking about breaking its treaty, they were paid money, by the way, of Guadalupe Hidalgo from the 1840s, that's in the London Telegraph. I mean, this is going on out of Mexico City. And they've made the minister in Mexico that invited Trump down resign. Because they invited him down there. I mean, Hillary won't even show up. They just think the fix is in. They think they have all the answers. They think we're done. But we're not. Now I have a lot more to cover, but going out to break, let's play this childlike fool. And you see this all over the web. The New York Times calls for the death of Donald Trump, saying go out and kill Donald Trump, kill his supporters. This is up on Infowars.com. Kill Trump and as many of his supporters as possible. And then you see mainstream media acting like this is cute, this is funny. And this poor young man really thinks he's doing good. He really thinks the mainstream media is his friend, distorting what Trump stands for and saying all this. I'd love to say to this guy, like, what is he, 18 years old? Okay, Mexico puts me in jail for 6 months to a year if I get caught illegally there and deports me anytime they want. He'll go, well, you are Mexico. Yeah, and France and Russia and everything else. I mean, at a certain point, it's just like, stop being a baby. It's this entitlement. It's like, I've been robbed. I've been cheated. Give me a break. The globalists want to extinguish what's left of the engine of freedom in America. I know America's got problems, but the globalists are the big issue. I'm going to skip this break. The New World Order is the issue, son. GMO is the issue. Gardasil is the issue. But I guarantee if I talk to this dumbass, at least till I broke through his cognitive dissonance, and I said, you know, every woman in Mexico that is 12 to 13 years old has been given a Gardasil shot that's been banned in Japan and India and all over and causes massive infertility by design and doesn't protect you from papillomavirus. That is one of the rarest forms of cancer to begin with. It is a contraceptive, just like Zika. Because I've told people this and met you on La Raza, their face, they just go, shut up, get out of my face, gringo. Just like David Duke, I had him on. I was like, we should come together. The globalists are doing Kim trailing us, bioweapons, we're all under attack, New World Order, humanity must come together. And he's like, oh, show, you're just covering up for the Jews. It's like, listen, we can argue all day who runs this. All I know is I don't want aluminum sprayed on anybody, no matter what color they are. I don't want people taking vaccines that admittedly have cancer viruses in almost every one of them. The Gardasil shot has killed, admittedly, hundreds and hundreds of people in the U.S. alone, and that's a very small portion of those we know that's killed. Autoimmune disorders, massive infertility. I've been saying for 12 years it's an infertility vaccine. Did they ever come after me? No, they didn't, because in the trials, it killed so many women. I've had the mothers on with their 12-year-old cheerleader daughter takes the shot, has convulsions for a week, bleeds out of their eyes, their butt, everywhere else, and dies. You know, I don't need to sit here and say, I'm not racist. I don't want to kill Mexicans. Don't take the shot. It's called understanding. People think you're either totally for open borders and world government or you want to kill all the Mexicans. No, how about I'm not going to be walked on. I'm not going to be run over. I'm not going to be attacked racially. I'm not going to be told I'm the author of everything bad in the world. You slipped down the stairs. I did it. But at the same time, I don't want to sit there and sterilize and kill you. See, I see you like I see myself. I want to be treated like I treat others. Well, I mean, let's play this guy talking about kill Donald Trump, kill everybody. This is just routine for the internet. Here it is.
We Mexicans have to kill Donald J. Trump before he becomes president. He is a threat to every single one of us Mexicans. There are many Mexicans living in the U.S. right now, and I'm asking them to kill Donald Trump before he becomes president. The ones in Mexico who have the means, I'm asking you to cross the border and go and kill Donald Trump and as many as his supporters as possible. Anywhere he goes, just try to bomb the place, shoot up the place, do something. Think about this. This is my reason why I'm asking for this. If you could go back in time and kill Hitler and kill the Nazis, would you do it? Now, we have a modern day Hitler, and we have to kill him before he gets into power. So I want you to spread this message, and I'm encouraging every single Mexican out there who has the guts to stand up for the Mexican people and to kill Trump and his Nazi followers. Let's do this. Viva Mexico.
Viva Mexico. What is Mexico? A captured globalist enclave just like the U.S. Trump went down there and said, let's get out from under the New World Order. Let's be prosperous. Let's end all this garbage. Let's end this big drug war. Let's, you know, let's do this. But this guy believes that the stuff he gets from the Spanish media that's globalist own and run is some message of goodness. Imagine if Trump does get killed by a Mexican national. How's that going to work? See, Trump knows he can't lose. Can't lose for winning. Can't win for losing. Not with this. When you do the right thing, you cannot lose, ladies and gentlemen. They kill Donald Trump, he wins. Don't kill him, he wins. Because they're one-sided trade deals to screw over the middle class and to end prosperity because the New World Order on record says they don't want you having your own economy. And with that said, let's start a little bit in the next hour. Then Rob Dew's joining us on vaccine, forced vaccine news that affects everybody. Let's start with Rachel Maddow last night. 13-minute report of total disinformation, twisting, and panicking. Because InfoWars is so horrible and we're run by Vladimir Putin. Let's start the report.
Will artificial intelligence enslave humanity before the globalists do? Ever wondered? Do you also know that Hillary Clinton uses a wheelchair? Her personal vehicle has had to be outfitted with a wheelchair lift because she is not a person who can actually walk. She secretly uses a wheelchair all those times you think you've seen her walking. She hasn't been walking. Did you know that? Did you also know that Hillary Clinton has Parkinson's disease? No, these things are true. I know they are true because I read them in the headlines. Here, I will prove it to you. Will artificial intelligence enslave humanity before the globalists
do? Pause.
AI, artificial...
Back it up, 10 seconds. Stephen Hawking, all the top futurists and scientists concur with our analysis. The Pentagon says they're worried about AI taking over. The globalists admit they're getting rid of humans. They admit that the future doesn't need us. That's the name of an article from Wired Magazine, Rachel. And then you sit there and show headlines like you're discrediting us. We didn't say Hillary couldn't walk. There are lifts on her vehicles. We have photos. We have it from the Secret Service. She's got major medical problems. A straw man, Maddow. You just misrepresented what we're saying. We did not say she can't walk. We said she has neurological problems, and major medical associations are saying she clearly has it. So there you go. Let's go back to her confidence game.
These things are true. I know they are true because I read them in the headlines. Here, I will prove it to you. Will artificial intelligence enslave humanity before the globalists do? AI, artificial intelligence, is taking over. So that one was a special report. Here was the shock headline on Hillary Clinton's wheelchair vehicle. Just one column over from that, there was also this seemingly competing news. Does Hillary Clinton have Parkinson's disease? The subhead there, we can all see she has some very serious health problems.
Hit pause. Back it up. In the WikiLeaks, in that article, she's trying to get Parkinson's medication. Just like Aberdeen says, do you need your earpiece? She's clearly got major problems, Maddow. But just keep trying to make us look like kooks. Let's continue.
One column over from that, there was also this seemingly competing news. Hillary Clinton, does Hillary Clinton have Parkinson's disease? The subhead there, we can all see she has some very serious health problems. At this same news source for all of those stories, you can also find important, maybe even life-saving health information about a powerful new micronutrient that fights the Zika virus. You'll be happy to know that once you have learned about this powerful new micronutrient, this service, this website will sell you that powerful new micronutrient, thus curing your Zika. They will also sell you that alongside their super male vitality potion.
Yeah, just try it, see what happens.
I gotta say, a little steep. 50.
All right, we're gonna come back with Cupcake. We're gonna come back with her. Of course, if you're a radio listener, you can't see. She's got InfoWars on screen. All right, so we're analyzing government propaganda, state-run media propaganda. 13-minute flip-out by Rachel Maddow, where she puts out the standard talking point that I work for the Russians and so does Donald Trump. And we're really evil because BBC, Associated Press, you know, we're doing their job reporting on the fact that selenium deficiency has been directly linked to the spread of the Zika virus in your body. And so we're horrible, evil profiteers for selling something at a very low price that people need. So let's continue with Rachel Maddow's misrepresentations.
Super male vitality potion, which is, I gotta say, a little steep. $59.95 plus shipping and handling for the increase to your male vitality. If that price tag is too high for your below-the-belt problems, fellas, you can spend about half that much to get the Survival Shield X2, which is apparently, according to the description there, leading the way into the next generation of super high-quality nascent iodine. The big bargain, though, I think, at this news site has got to be this one, their Deep Cleanse Elixir. And I don't quite, I have to say, I don't quite totally understand the description here. It either has powerful nanocolloidal zeolites, or it will get rid of your powerful nanocolloidal zeolites. I can't quite tell, but your neocolloidal zeolites will never be the same. All of this incredible news about the artificial intelligence that is enslaving humanity before the globalists do, and the secret micronutrients that cure Zika and the male vitality potions and all and the nascent iodine.
It's horrible.
All of this stuff is, of course, available through InfoWars.com. InfoWars is the conspiracy theory website, sort of mega website, where the dimmer bulbs among us have long gone to get themselves brightened up without
bulbs.
Benefit of a surge protector.
So horrible. It's
the government lies out of hand. You're saying, well, then why do you believe in the moon landing? Because I have sources inside NASA. They put on some fake stuff for you. See, there was a lie. See, it's not just did we go or didn't we go. You were shown the Tinker Toy stuff because you're not supposed to see what they really got. You're not supposed to know the thousands of astronauts that have died. Oh, yes. In fact, I should do a whole show on that.
We're already in a tyranny. And then Operation Jade Helm gets announced. It was put on the Army website last week. We reported on it first.
And they'll have some real missions that are legitimate mixed in to confuse the idiot public, kind of like cyanide pills, you know, taste like sugar or 80% sugar. So Sandy Hook is a synthetic, completely fake, with actors, in my view, manufactured. I couldn't believe it at first. I knew they had actors there, clearly, but I thought they killed some real kids. And it just shows how bold they are.
You saw them stage Fast and Furious. Folks, they staged Aurora. They staged Sandy Hook. The evidence is just overwhelming.
But the reason there's so many gay people now is because it's a chemical warfare operation. I have the government documents where they said they're going to encourage homosexuality with chemicals so that people don't have children. I even catch myself, Bob, drinking out of these estrogen mimickers. For those watching on PrisonPlanet.tv, here's the inside of this juice box. And if they zoom in any more, see that thin plastic? It's got it. And I'm letting my children drink this. After you're done drinking your little juice.
So, again, they've taken a bunch of clips out of context. Some of it's accurate, some of it's not. And then I specified, right after I said that, I said thousands of test pilots have died in the NASA program. Hundreds they admit to. It is in the thousands. I mean, thousands have died trying to have troops jump out of C-130s with, you know, vehicles and tanks and motorcycles. And you hear about a helicopter accident. But, yeah, there's a big secret space program. Everybody knows that. But they try to sit there and play games. They didn't show that I had in studio the late, great Raymond Teague, who's famously running the cameras on the moon and Skylab and everything else. That came from him and others. And former head of Star Wars program we also had on the broadcast. So, see, that's how they take it all out of context. Then they move on to Trump and Putin after this. It's amazing what they're doing. This attempted prosecution will not work. Folks can see it's all heavily edited out of context. Infowars.com. We're running the Rachel Maddow special right now. All right, so Rachel Maddow went into an unprecedented, and again, this is a White House mouthpiece. Doesn't have a lot of viewers, but it does get parroted by other media, so it's somewhat important. Going into a 13-minute conniption fit of misrepresentation, lies, edited videos, distortions, you name it, to attack yours truly, because her lordship last week attacked, of course, InfoWars. And so if you just joined us, she's already like 5 minutes into demonization, 6 minutes in, and all the horrible things we're doing. I mean, we claim you need oxygen. We claim you need water. We claim you need vitamin C. We're horrible people. We sell things to fund ourselves. This is unprecedentedly evil. That's why we're running the Mr. Maddow special. 50% off Super Male Vitality, 50% off Deep Cleanse, 100% off Survival Shield Nation Iodine X2. I mean, there's major iodine deficiency. We have record-level thyroid problems in this country. Hillary has one, and they will not tell you that it's because of the fluoride in the water. They just make jokes about it all day. The federal government had them put iodine in salt starting in the 20s, and IQs went up 15% in the Midwest. Google it. Then they started taking it out. We're just saying, if you choose, this is the true, pure iodine. And yes, we fund ourselves with it. So the Rachel Maddow special isn't having ratings yet because it's brand new. Went up about an hour ago. But you can get big discounts right now on those. It helps fund the operation. All right. Continuing here, ladies and gentlemen, let's go back to Rachel Chris Hayes Maddow. I say it because I think they're both the same person, an actor. I'm joking, but it is a striking resemblance. Maybe she's the daughter of Bill Clinton. Okay, I'm joking. I mean, that's as fictitious as the stuff she's saying on her show. Let's go back to it.
Tearing us down and removing us, the decision has been made. Cheer up. The post-human era is dawning. The plan is an asexual humanoid, even if they decide to keep us around.
You got all that? I actually think, having reflected upon this thesis...
Hey, pause. Here is the asexual humanoid... Right here, mad that I'm talking about the admitted globalist plan that I'm reading out of the Journal of Science. I'm reading out of the Financial Times of London. I'm reading out of Wired Magazine. You've all seen these articles. I'm covering it, and she's just acting like I'm totally crazy. Like Obamacare having death panels, or Obamacare not letting you keep your doctor, or Obamacare doubling your prices or tripling them. It's all admitted now. We have Gruber saying, thank God we're stupid. Well, I'm not stupid, Maddow. Just because you're another arrogant, you know, person with full of criminology who thinks she's invincible, you're not, jackass. So let's continue with Rachel Maddow.
That last part there, I think when he says that the eugenics transhumanist cult that wants to confuse the general species ahead of rendering us down and removing us, I think when he says rendering us down, I literally think he means that we're going to be melted and turned into candles, like they're going to use our fat to make
soap. Let's hit pause, slime bag. I think back her up. She, we're getting to her religion here, and she doesn't like it. Okay, she's a parasite. She's into preying on you. She's into keeping you in the dark. And so, no, rendering us down means using our energy, our developments, our innovations, our technology, our will to build your world government, to build your technocracy. Then you merge with machines, and we get exterminated. That's what Ray Kurzweil says. That's what the globalists say. That's the plan, lady. You're there making a joke about stuff that's known, just like TPP. Just like any of this, I'm telling you what the plan is. It's like, I mean, they've had pieces a few weeks ago going, he's crazy. He says danger of nuclear war has never been worse. I've got all these top scholars, top military publications saying the same thing. That's where I'm getting it, lady. But there's something about these arrogant parasites. They just think they're so smart. No, globalists that took control of society through fraud finance you, but you have no viewers. But we do occasionally show you to illustrate the arrogance of a clown. Let's go back to it.
I think he's literal on that. That is the pilot, the captain of America's conspiracy theory mothership, Alex Jones. And Alex Jones has been around forever. I'm assuming he will be around forever. He says Hillary Clinton is going to kill him. He has publicly asked Hillary Clinton not to kill him, so who knows? But honestly, he's going to be around for a while. It's a very lucrative gig.
Oh, now it's a lucrative gig. I've been around forever. Oh, my gosh. They're bemoaning the fact that it's hard to go after me. They're bemoaning the fact that good elements of the government have got us watched constantly. And every time they send somebody, they get snatched up like that. I mean, you cannot stand it, can you? You cannot stand it. And so you sit there implying that we're the big mothership of all this and that we're just spewing all this disinfo. That is not what's happening here. The truth is the globalists have this plan. They think we don't count. We're going to discuss the plan and see what the public thinks about it. And the public doesn't like your plan. Back to Mr. Maddow.
Hillary Clinton is going to kill him. He has publicly asked Hillary Clinton not to kill him, so who knows? But honestly, he's going to be around for a while. It's a very lucrative gig he's got going on.
Hit pause again. Basically got back it up. I want to just say something about this again. Hillary brags that she came, she saw, he died. She overthrows innocent countries. She financed the murder of hundreds of thousands of Christians in Africa, hundreds of thousands in Syria. The whole world admits, yeah, they single out Christians and kill them. They hate us. I mean, you're a monster. She's got a trail of death behind her. They fire people that say she needs medical help, like Dr. Drew. Of course I'm pointing out we're in danger. And if I do get killed, she's the number one suspect. And see, I ruin your fun because other people are supposed to just sit there and cower but never say it. I don't care, lady. I don't care what you say about me. I love 1,000 articles a day attacking me. I love a traitor like you attacking me. It's the most beautiful music I ever heard, sweetheart. But you're right, because you know it. I will be around just as long as God wants me to. I ignored it for a long time, the providence of my life. But I tell you, my entire life, people that have double-crossed me or enemies that come after me, they've never had a good fate. And it wasn't men doing it. And that's what you can't stand, can you? That there's something bigger than you and your satanic new world order. There's a whole universe around this little planet, and it's run by God, big G-O-D, exclamation point. And it's the God that gave us all this prosperity, all this life, men and women loving each other, children, all these blessings. And you are only the test for us to go to the next level. So I thank God for the persecution. I thank God for everything. I will not get mad at God if I lose everything tomorrow. Everything. My family, everything. I'm committed. Don't you get it, lady? I love God. You don't. It's over. The tanks are rolling into Berlin, lady. You're going to get it politically. Understand? You already lost. So act all powerful and act like you're invincible all day long, lady. You don't have any spirit, and you know it. Arrogance you have. Understanding? You don't. Back to Rachel Maddow.
Off the fringe and became bigger fringe when he proclaimed that 9/11 was not carried out by Al-Qaeda. 9/11 was actually committed by the U.S. government against our own country.
Again, I pointed out that Saudi Arabia working with criminal elements of our government and the Carlyle Group was clearly involved. It was a standout. I interviewed the FBI agents, CIA, you name it, broke it all down. And now it's all come out in 28 pages. And I've been proven correct again, lady. So let's continue.
He earned from that 9/11 trutherism, and he has now been running with it and expanding on that idea very successfully for the last 15 years. And you sometimes have people ask, especially people in other countries, well, look at the American electorate. They'll ask in very sort of serious sociological or poli-sci terms, you know, why is it?
They always like to act like foreigners are all smarter than us, and we're all so stupid. We're kind of in our own bubble, and it is true. We've been the target of the globalist takeover, so we do have some problems. But, oh, all these pseudo-intellectuals and poli-sci's and agiprops and, you know, oh, so fancy. They all look at us and say, what's the problem? And then she's like, oh, yeah, I know. We're intellectuals. You know, when you've hitched your wagon to a corpse like Hillary, you're a joke, lady. I mean, I've been around some of these globalists and some of these meetings and events over the years, and they're the most empty, unhappy, neurotic, screwed up weirdos. I mean, I would want to hang around with you if hell froze over. that you think you're elitist. No, you're the trash that the evil spiders of the New World Order put in charge because you're so traitorous and don't have a soul or don't have a working soul that you do horrible things to your fellow humans and get off on pissing on everybody. We're going to skip this network break. This is so important. Let's continue with Rachel Maddow. And by the way, if you're a radio listener, she has an image of myself, Donald Trump, and Putin up there. This is the new normal. God forbid Putin pay people to get married and have kids because the Russians are all dying. God forbid Trump wants to do the same thing. God forbid I don't want GMOs. And God forbid Trump's exposing that. He gets no money from Big Pharma and that they're making the new national export from Russia organic food. Oh, my gosh, this is so horrible. God forbid Putin battle radical Islamists all over the world. God forbid Trump link up with Russia. God forbid we not bankrupt ourselves with all these wars. And their new McCarthyism, when McCarthy was right about how the globals were running Russia, but it wasn't Russia taking us over, it was the globals taking Russia over. That's when they took McCarthy out. They called it the new McCarthyism. That's not fair. This is 50 times beyond that. I mean, they've got national newscasts every day literally saying, I'm a Russian agent, because I know George Soros bragged on CNN that he started a war with an elected government, overthrew the Ukrainian government, is trying to start a war with Russia. Some weirdo that my grandfathers, who are both dead in their graves. My mom's dad gave himself to medical science, with others dead in the grave in Teague, Texas. And it's not fair that this Nazi collaborator, a master Nazi, is running around with all these weird liberals with big, long giraffe necks. It's like a science fiction movie. Like, what the hell's going on? Like, worshiping real Nazis and then calling me one. It's like, what is your problem, man? Why are you so scumbaggish? Why are you so fraudulent? Why are you so fake? What the hell's your problem? I can't believe you're so weak. It's your followers. You come from families of trash. It really comes down to that. And it's those of us that don't come from trash who are to blame for letting you do this. Well, guess what? We're not going to let you anymore. And so you're going to feel our will pressing against you 24/7 hours a day at every level, economically, culturally, spiritually, militarily. Every hour, every day, every millisecond, pounding you with the truth, focusing on you. We have the will. We are the future. You have already fallen. You are fallen. Now go back to hell. Go back to your God. Get behind me, Satan. Now back to Rachel Maddow.
That an advanced and fairly well-educated country like ours is nevertheless getting to be as susceptible to political conspiracy theories as broadly uneducated countries in faraway lands. Why is it that we get
See, Americans are dumb scum. When her viewers, we've talked to the street, cannot find their butts with both hands. I mean, again, it's all how she's this big intellectual. Oh, there's the Federal Reserve's not private. Everything's fine. Let's go back to her.
More susceptible conspiracy theories as conspiracy theories as time goes on. We don't seem like the kind of country where they would have as much traction as they do now in our contemporary era in politics.
Yes, the AP and others admit you have a 6% trust rate. You've lost all credibility. Does that mean everything that people put out against you or questions we have is completely accurate? No, we're trying to be accurate. But you're known discredited 2 weeks ago trash already at the landfill, sweetheart. We're the new little flowers in the springtime coming up out of the grass, baby. It's up to us to lose the future, and I don't want to lose the future. I have goodwill towards people. You don't, you bloated parasite. Every place globalists run turns into a poor, squalor-filled hellhole because you're demons and don't like to see prosperity. You want to see a bunch of poor people you rule over. You're a feudal lord. But you're not even as good as old feudal lords who are willing to fight for their slaves. You're all bark and no bite, all hat and no cattle, all talk and no action. Let's go back to Chris Hayes.
Part of the reason why we're so susceptible to conspiracy theories right now is that guys like Alex Jones make a ton of money circulating them as widely as they possibly can.
This is class envy. They get billions in taxpayer money when NBC still owned it a few years ago. She even got a bonus off your taxpayer money. NPR gets it. These big corporations get corporate welfare. They run these media outlets at losses to spew their disinformation, their anti-gun, their anti-Christian crap, ban the founding fathers, get rid of the American flag, all this stuff. And then we're bad that we're here in Texas selling T-shirts and books and videos and nutraceuticals. We're evil because we make money. She cuts the commercial in a few minutes with where they're making money. No credibility. Hypocrites. The obvious paradox. She thinks her viewers are idiots, and a lot of them are. They're sitting there listening and feeling intellectual and feeling powerful as their god, this weird asexual android, arrogantly sits there in a con game smiling like she runs the planet. And I guarantee you, Rachel Maddow is a miserable, miserable person. You could not pay me $1 billion to spend 1 week with her. Let's continue.
And they use multiple platforms. They use talk radio and the internet, and they live stream their kind of fake TV shows, and they make a very good living doing it. And they're going to be around because of it for a long time. And usually this kind of stuff has no major effect on the United States of America other than lowering our median IQ.
All right, pause. Back it up again. You're stupid. We lower the IQ. We're dumbed down media, even though it's complex historical analysis, which you think your audience doesn't get. So you dumb it down and then prey on them. When we are the organic response to your technocracy, and you say normally this doesn't have any effect on the United States, it's having a total effect. Let me give you a little headline, sweetheart. I knew 15 years ago when UKIP was getting no attention, and I was having Nigel Farage on every month, that he was telling me, and he said it on air, that the majority of the new UKIP members they got were from this show, sweetheart. Just the sidewash of this broadcast just blew holes in the EU. And that was 15 years ago, baby. So you sit there and talk about how we don't have any influence when you realize you're covering it every night because we've devastated you. And we're going to go on devastating you. You took our restraint as weakness. You took our calm as support for what you're doing, and that's not what it is. And now you're beginning to see the preparations we've made. We have preparations for every eventuality you launch. And I'm not talking about little old me. I'm just a focal point. That's it. Kind of a stream of the resistance. An oracle. For all the patriots and the news and the information and what you're noticing is when you try to cut us down, you make us 1,000 times more powerful each time. And just as trash like you has learned throughout history, you're weak. Now back to the panicking Maddow.
And making us seem slightly more embarrassing on an international stage. Right, for every additional year, they circulate their insane alien lizard people theories of everything.
No, we get a little. I don't cover the alien lizard thing. I've had guests on that say it's like demons run things. Why are the British royals always caught with dead kids? What the hell's going on? And you study the elite, they're in all sorts of whacked out stuff. I mean, I'm not the one at Skull and Bones that has gay sex in giant pits of feces. That's movies that are admittedly history, produced and starred in with Matt Damon and Robert De Niro, you know, the Good Shepherd. I mean, I'm not the one worshiping Satan in pits of feces, lady. All I'm saying is you people are crazy, like Caligula marrying his horse, making it the head of the Senate. That's all I'm saying. And our audience knows that, sweet pie.
A bit dumber, and that's the major effect it has on the United States of America. But this year is different. Because this year, that little corner, that little niche
Let's hit pause. But back it up. They know Trump, by the way, is like 15 points ahead. That's why they're so panicking right now. They don't know what to do. They know he's going to challenge a stolen election. So they're sending the feds in to take it over, the globalists. And notice how they use all these videos that aren't even that blurred on YouTube. And they use like 5-, 6-, 7-year-old stuff, 10-year-old stuff. And then I know those videos, they're not that blurred. They blur them on purpose to make it look like it's this horrible, low-quality crap, when I've actually found, without being manipulative, people like grainy stuff better than crystal clear, because crystal clear is so associated with you. So at every level, they're there going, we'll blur it out and make him look bad and blow up the screen and make him look fat. I mean, not all the tricks they're playing. We don't use those tricks, but we're too busy just spewing truth at you like a giant flamethrower. But this is what they're doing. If you're a TV viewer, you can see this. It's a joke. But, oh, let's go back to the crystal clear. I wish it wasn't. Of giraffe neck. Here it is.
States of America. But this year is different. Because this year, that little corner, that little niche of organized and profitable American insanity.
Which you're so fearful
this
of.
This year, they're out of their corner because this year they're presidential politics. After NBC and MSNBC and Iraq and Afghanistan Veterans of America hosted the Commander-in-Chief Forum last night with Hillary Clinton and Donald Trump. After that last night, this morning, Donald Trump Jr. woke up and tweeted this direct link.
All right, pause. I want to explain how this works. Okay, whatever they're most fearful of, they act like they've got you so that weak members of the campaign go, oh, my God, Trump. They're really going after us on this. And Trump's been in the meetings. He goes, that's exactly what we want. Attack more on that. He gets it. They want to set the parameters of the debate where, oh, my God, Hillary's health, it's totally discredited. She's healthier than Muhammad Ali when he was 25 years old. You know, she can run a marathon right now, you know, in her sleep and do jumping jacks backwards. Oh, Trump, you're discredited putting this earpiece thing out. Oh, my God, you're in so much trouble, because that's what they're scared of, folks. Yeah, Hillary's shine is worn off as time wears on. And we've got the video up on Infowars.com where they've got her in this tent for like 45 minutes a couple days ago in Ohio, in Cleveland, and they've got stretchers being run in there and people freaking out. This is pretty big. We're going to be talking about that with Rob Dew. Also, his children got a letter home from school. Trying to imply that the flu vaccine is totally safe and you got to take it, even though you've already opted out with the health department. So we're going to talk about forced vaccines already have in California coming to the rest of the country, what a serious situation that is. But I wanted to finish up with Rachel Maddow. Before I do that, it's important to note that we are running a lot of specials right now, one of the biggest ever on storable foods and other products at InfoWarsStore.com. 30 to 40% off on the storable foods. And we've now expanded the Rachel Maddow special, or the Mr. Maddow specials, as it's actually called, to make a joke out of her. And we're talking a whole bunch of discounts on nutraceuticals that she personally demonized, like we're horrible, horrible people. 15% off Deep Cleanse, 15% off Supermental Vitality. We're going to extend the 20% off Survival Shield, Nascent Iodine X2. I mean, folks, if you have deficiencies in real iodine, most of it's not the real iodine. You can't absorb it. It's a huge game changer. I mean, go research it for yourself. Just type in IQs went up 15 points after government added iodine to salt. Then they took it out. You'll get Associated Press. You'll get Business Insider. You'll get the actual studies. I mean, I'm not the one saying this. It's like a big deal. I take it every day. My kids take it. Well, let's kick his mic on if we can.
Yeah.
Rob News here.
Where the they make it in these big glass vats. It's all done with glass. It's not done with plastic. I've seen the crystals. They keep them in a vault because this stuff is can be dangerous until it's.
Well, you have to under what is it? The Drug Enforcement Agency.
Right. Exactly. It's
because they use it to make a bunch of drugs. Yeah.
Exactly. But and you know when we took it out,
one drop eats through like the floor, like Alien.
Yeah. They put it on the hot plate and just a little bit of heat applied underneath it, and the fumes start coming up. This stuff
purple. Is
powerful. And when you take it, you'll taste the power in it. I mean, you could taste, you know when you get something that's like really salty or briny, you eat seaweed, it's got that power in it. You can just feel it. This is the same way.
So, absolutely. I didn't mean to get off into the whole thing about that, but we don't normally cover Maddow. She attacks us pretty much every day now.
Yeah.
I mean, it's four or five times a week, but this is this long diatribe of disinfo. And they're all about who controls the narrative and who listens to who, and I mean, they're such totalitarians.
Oh, and we're lowering the IQ of people. She doesn't even know what a zeolite is. She has no idea. It's things that take toxins out of your body. You know, you need this stuff. People don't realize. And what do they push? They push pharmaceutical products. They these crappy weight loss pills that don't work and that are filled with garbage. That's the kind of stuff they throw out at their listeners. And they think their listeners Are their listeners think they're smart because they watch those programs?
Let me ask you this question.
It really is a program, what they do.
It's all about groupthink. It's all peer pressure.
That email you got today.
Chicago Tribune writer. We're like, okay, you're saying the devil incarnate. Come on the show.
Yeah.
I would never do that. You have no credibility. It's like, like he has this power to say
no. We don't
no.
even know who you are.
Age Freelix
is probably
and Carl the Cuck have all been offered $10,000 apiece. Come on the show.
I wish they would. It'd be great.
They're just scared.
Yeah. They're afraid. That's how it is. Once you challenge them on one thing, they literally just start freaking out. I've been to these Trump rallies. You ask them a couple questions. They just start.
And by the way, I'm not scared of the media that I've turned down 20-something major profiles. I said, no, I'll give you all 15 minutes on the phone and answer your questions, or you can all come here and do a press conference.
Yeah.
But I'm not going to sit here and spend, 20 days not running our operation or doing news
person
to sit there and kiss the ass of some reporter who's going to then put out some disinfo piece. I just write whatever your crap is.
Notice how in Maddow's piece, they took stuff from like 2010, 2011. They find the oldest stuff when we're in the old studio.
Oh, no, they found some stuff from like 2009, 2008. Yeah.
And it's just...
But it's not even... The point is they even blurred that to make it all look crazy.
Right.
And they messed the audio up. It's like...
Yeah, we got to put the filters on it. And it's just funny the way they attack you constantly. But each attack, you grow stronger.
We all grow stronger. But the point is that because they're discredited. And they still don't get their discredited.
No, they don't. They think their narrative is what everybody goes with. And their narrative is the one that's not trusted by anybody. Except those old geriatric people who believe that what comes on TV is the truth.
All right, let's finish up with Matt out here. I'll try not to comment too much because I need to get this flu news. And Paul Watson's got a new article about the truth about Hillary's handler. It's very powerful. And we also want to play some clips of Hillary and the emergency stretcher and her in a medical tent for 45 minutes. Can you imagine if Trump was in a medical tent for 45 minutes?
Oh, it would be national news every day of the week for 2 weeks straight.
She clearly looks like she's dying.
And those guys are wearing body armor. You can see the picture on Infowars.com. You can see... Three men pushing the gurney, and they have body armor on.
All right, let's go back to Chris Hayes. Here it is.
And tweeted this direct link to the Alex Jones InfoWars expose of what really happened on board the Intrepid last night at the Commander-in-Chief Forum. You got to hit the shift lock key because it's all in capital letters when you get there. But what he's linked to is this InfoWars Alex Jones piece. Was Hillary wearing an earpiece during last night's presidential forum? This is an Alex Jones InfoWars conspiracy theory exclusive. They took a screen grab from last night's Commander-in-Chief forum that, with the light hitting Hillary Clinton's left ear just exactly in the right way, it appears to show some sort of suspicious glare in that if you wanted to take this accusation seriously, that she was wearing an earpiece, she was on stage for more than 20 minutes. You could take lots of different angles, camera angles, shadows, showing the same ear, but without the glinting.
By the way, we've caught them blurring out Donald Trump supporter shirts. We've caught them editing things, cutting feeds constantly. Why wouldn't they Photoshop out stuff?
Oh, yeah, exactly.
The web was exploding with this earpiece thing. We didn't break this.
Right.
And I'm not backing away from it. I said, is she wearing an earpiece? We said that about George W. Bush. He clearly had the whole backpack on.
Yeah, he had the whole
deal. I mean, look, here, we don't believe known liars.
Right.
And Hillary, it's not like she was 5 years ago where she was still all there. She's got to have Secret Service and doctors run up when somebody asks her a question. She's like, spaces out.
It's okay. It's okay.
And she's got to have somebody tell her it's okay. So, and then you got Uma Abedin's email saying, do you need your earpiece? I mean, that's WikiLeaks.
You can even see it when Richard Reeves asked her the question about the emails being hacked, her email being hacked. She goes, absolutely not. Absolutely not. And then the guy's like, all right, come on. And they say, come on, here we go. And she goes, here we go. It's like she's a literal.
By the way, we should put all that. It is like she's mind controlled.
Here we go. As he starts walking over this.
Yeah. We should show all that because it's like, she'll be like, they go, it's okay, go forward. I will go forward. Will go forward. And exactly. And then everybody went, oh, look at Jones claiming they were hacked. It was admittedly hacked months before Richard Reeves asked the question.
Yes.
She just admitted at the forum two nights ago that it was hacked.
Right.
Admittedly hacked a year ago.
And we got her lying.
But point is that, we're discredited again, Rachel Maddow said.
Right. Yeah.
All right, let's go back to, I'm going to be honest, I'm not attracted to men, but I'm becoming a little bit gay for Rachel Maddow. Here it is.
Right? Here are other images of Hillary Clinton's ear. The ear in question from the same event last night, none of which show the secret earpiece that Alex Jones has exposed.
See, The ear looked weird.
I mean, consider the source.
If you go back
and pause, we should analyze that.
It had the little angles on it where it looks like it was messed with.
I was about to say, we didn't script this. You're looking at that. There's suddenly more pixelation. Yeah. They're even that lazy.
You're starting to look at it.
It's like Obama's birth certificate was in six layers and used WordPress.
Right.
And Microsoft fonts where it's like blobs from a printer, mm-hmm. but the C's are all the same, even though every time they're different, like a snowflake with how you hit the key. And then it's crazy. I mean, I don't even know what to say. You use Microsoft Word on it with a typewriter font. It wasn't real. I don't know what you're hiding. I don't know what's going on, but you don't put things out in six layers. I mean, they put them out in layers. They don't even flatten the product.
Forgery.
They don't even flatten the project.
Right.
And exactly. Let's back that up. If you're a TV viewer, you're onto something here. It's blurred.
All right. So go forward in that.
This is crazy. These people are nuts.
Just slowly scroll forward. You can see one of the ear shots that when she says these are all the angles that it wasn't there.
They're just targeting morons.
It was that one right there. Look at the air.
You can blow it up. Full screen that. It's clearly pixelated right there.
Yeah. Look at that.
Oh, my God.
And it's worse. Like, this one's kind of, you can see the edge of her nose, and it's kind of pixelated. But look at the ear. Mega pixelation right there.
Which means you blurred it.
You can see it.
These people, there's no end to these people.
Oh, my God.
This is like,
wow.
And I wasn't even sure she had an earpiece, but look at this. Look at the freaking out.
Wow. That's amazing.
I didn't know this. She was 45 minutes in a tent. Everybody freaking out. And people running up in body armor with stretchers like the world was ending.
Yeah.
And she's all.
And then you got.
What about the green globlets coming out? I've never seen any cough drops that big.
Well, we know what that is. I mean, we've already shown it. We have the video footage.
Those are baby Maddow's coming out.
This is the creeps coming
out. That's how Maddow mates.
Yeah, we actually had the microphone. We tuned the microphones. You actually hear them talking as they come out.
We're being sarcastic there, Maddow. We're not talking bad about your mating rituals. I bet Hillary is a fan of Maddow.
Oh, yeah.
I wonder if Maddow could ever stay in the same hotel room like Uma.
They take off a couple of floors, so there's always time to put somebody else in there. Who knows?
That's a party. Hey, let's go back to Chris Hayes. Go ahead.
From the same event last night, none of which show the secret earpiece that Alex Jones has exposed. But, I mean, consider the source here. Consider the context. This earpiece story at Alex Jones InfoWars, right, it's literally running alongside other headlines that are up at that same website today that say that Hillary Clinton uses a wheelchair, that she has Parkinson's disease. InfoWars also announcing today that they've got the video proof that Hillary Clinton is a mass murderer. So, you know, there's a secret earpiece thing. You know, that's a journalistically sound.
Let's pause. She admits that she, quote, launched the failed policy of the failed Senate of Libya that's killed close to 100,000 people. She admits she's the author of what happened in Syria. Everybody knows that. Top generals are all saying it. She just hopes her audience
into bombing Yugoslavia the second time, which was even more bombs than the first time.
Which, to back up the Muslims taking over. Let's go back to her.
Compared to the rest of the stuff they're putting out there. That could be sort of
Hillary's a warmonger. They only backed all the Iraq attacks for no reason. Back it up. And the sanctions that killed 500,000 Iraqis that her mentor says was a good price to pay.
Exactly. 500,000.
But Matt Elkin. Matt Elkin's like, my Adam's apple's bigger than yours, Alex. So that means I got bigger huevos. Okay, I get it. Go ahead. You do got bigger huevos telling people Hillary isn't a war criminal.
Of the stuff they're putting out there. That could be sort of a mainstream scandal. I mean, this year, in 2016, with Donald Trump at the top of the ticket for the Republican Party.
It really could. It could be mainstream. She's a warmonger.
Yeah.
It could be mainstream that she backed Al-Qaeda and ISIS. That's all admitted facts.
We came, we saw, he died. She says it right there.
And then you got to do a hyena laugh, though. Let's do some green globules.
Excuse me.
It's like war with Russia. Kill. You know, just like all these phonic, weird women with short haircuts, like demonic chickens at the Monster Chicken. They're just like kill. Anyways,
we predict now she'll never have a clear glass again. There'll always be like some sort of. You know, it'll be.
I'm telling you, we got to take memes of that. We got to take, like, you know, those little 7-second deals that
look
like, bleh.
Well, we have one.
There are no green globules. Obamacare's free. I didn't have sex with that. I didn't have sex with green globlets. Let's go back to our sweetheart, Maddow. Here it is.
Alex Jones is no longer just broadcasting to your fillings and your molars.
Good pause. Oh. Mm-hmm. So we never talked about broadcasting people's molars. So just more crap. Like you said, I once said there were giant wasps live under the UN building and run everything.
But actually, people do get radio signals in their molars. That has happened because that's even
been in like Time Magazine decades ago that it was true that somehow it was close enough to the transmitter.
Yeah.
Sometimes it would resonate. You would hear like a little mirror.
You hear it in your mouth. And that's a dentist joke, actually. It's like a common knowledge dentist joke. Your dad has probably even heard. You know, hey, if you turn your head this way.
But the point is, we're not saying that.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, let's go back to her. Here it is.
He is apparently with the upper echelons of the Republican presidential campaign. Yeah. Is reading and citing and circulating, even at this late date in the campaign.
Election fraud?
And it matters because it's not just the kook fringe. It's not just the sort of remunerative conspiracy theory world of that part of the conservative media machine. It's not even just wacky people who have made their way into Republican politics at a surprising height. This is now the top of the Republican ticket. And like it's after Labor Guam's Day, and this is a presidential year. And so all day today,
I'm about to say, hit pause. I'm back around. Republicans, on average, have got some idiot people.
Oh, yeah.
Like, I mean, they wanted to attack Iraq, and I'm like, hey, it's Saudi Arabia, and you know, oh, shut up, traitor, commie, you hit me. But, I mean, I got Democrats on average, you've been doing this a long time. Tell me if I'm wrong. Are they not, on average, the dumbest people you've ever seen?
The island will tilt if too many people get on
it. Let me, Admiral, if too many people get on the island of Guam, will it tip over, sir, because it's floating? I mean, this is just...
it really is bizarre. Oh, man.
Hey, let's go back to low-information voter queen.
Yeah.
Or should I say King, Maddow, here it is.
Did the InfoWars Alex Jones conspiracy theory. All day today, this was the headline about the Commander-in-Chief Forum at the mega conservative news site that drives more traffic online than anything else on the right. This was the headline anything all day else. Today at Ever. The Drudge Report.
Yeah, hit pause. Back it up again. All lies. You have to keep doing it. I'm sorry it's taking an hour to do. Drudge has more traffic than the New York Times and Facebook both combined. That's admitted, even by the New York Times. She says, oh, more traffic than anybody on the right.
Yeah.
Lady, you don't even show up as a blip on the radar screen. I mean, you are a joke. We don't even cover you, but one out of 20 times. It's just you're so comical. She's getting her biggest audience of her life right now.
Yeah.
It's like the Young Turds.
I got to
Their show is imploding. Less and less viewers, everything. And they just get up and go, Alex wanted to come on here because he needed an audience. He's desperate.
Yeah.
They're like, hey, Alex, please come on. I'm like, I'll be back later. They're a joke. You're a joke. Here, let's go back to her.
They literally led with this as the most important thing in presidential politics right now.
I think it's pretty important.
Which on the one hand is hilarious, right? On the other hand, this is this great moment. This is like a snapshot, a microcosm of why this campaign is hard to follow, sort of where it's hard to get a sense of what the narrative is of the campaign
so
this year, why it can
conference?
Be sort of maddening to try to follow what's going on in the campaign, why it can be sort of painfully ridiculous to try to follow what's going on in the campaign on any given day now. It's because there really are just these two sides in the campaign. We are in a presidential election contest. We have two major parties, and these are the two candidates for those parties.
This is a cult. I have nothing against lesbians, okay? I mean, seriously, I don't even just say I don't have anything against lesbians. I don't. I mean, I literally don't. I don't, whatever. I mean, I'm not judging them. I think they got good taste. The point is that she's the god of lesbians, though. I mean, Hillary is. It's like, it's well known. It's like they'll defend her no matter what she does. She's vomiting globulates up and has ambulances following around, and she's falling over, and there's a guy with an EpiPen. I mean, this can't go on much longer. This is so biblical that she's rotting right in front of us.
They have to suspend reality. And we saw that at the convention, the Democratic National Convention. These people were like, I don't like that shirt, but there's a place for you in our party. Well, what about the stolen emails? What about the hacked emails that say they were literally giving it to her? Well, you know, that's not good, but we still got to support
her. Well, it's okay that she's a warmonger and a criminal and stole out the communist Chinese because she's a woman. It's like, no.
And that's bad.
Oh, you just don't like a woman. And I'm like, I'm going to respond to that at this point. You know, you don't like her. She's a lesbian. I mean, she admittedly had reportedly a boy. And I don't want a boy. We better have a girl. Abort it. Just had a girl just for PR purposes.
Yeah.
I mean, this is just, these people are anti-human, folks. I don't know what else to say about them, you know? It's just they're trash. And I got to tell you, this is historic what's happening. These people are floundering.
Mm-hmm. The last 3 months have really just illustrated. Everything they say turns out to be a lie. It's going to come out eventually that she had something in her ear. She had an earpiece in her ear.
It's going to come out that she's had all these brain surgeries. We know she's had them. It's going to come out she's got Parkinson's. She goes, I need Parkinson's medication in the damn email. I mean, you know, I mean, it's going to come out.
The symptoms of Parkinson's means you have Parkinson's. And we're not even saying she has Parkinson's. We're just asking the question because.
But Dr. Drew wanted to help her, so he got fired. Let's finish up with Maddox. I'm going to get to this. I'm going to get this Millie Weaver
1940s
piece.
1940s technology.
Here it is.
Campaign on any given day now. It's because there really are just these two sides in the campaign. We are in a presidential election contest. We have two major parties, and these are the two candidates for those parties. And it just so happens that one of them is stuck on the Juice Boxes Make You Gay channel. And the other one is nevertheless trying to conduct a campaign as if this is normal politics.
Who's a better looking
lesbian? These are not two campaigns that are doing the same thing. These are not two candidates who are making the same kind of case. These are not two political organizations that are even speaking the same language. I mean, one side is literally tweeting InfoWars, which believes that invisible alien lizard people drive most U.S. policy now. This is from the
Hit pause. You bought the Zwarg, is that his name?
Yeah, it was one. It was something from Star Trek.
His name's Zwarg, right?
I think so.
There's an extinct volcano, and my son liked it.
Gorm or something.
Gorm. Yeah. There's an extinct volcano outside town. Looks like the same place they shot the famous one where he fights the lizard.
Well, he invents a cannon. He like makes a cannon out of
exactly.
All these
parts. I said I wanted to make a joke video out of that, but we never did it.
Right.
And as I was supposed to be Captain Kirk and beat Zwarg, but we didn't do it. So then I just made a joke where I was like talking about how Obamacare is free and wonderful. Right. It's a joke video. I'm not saying lizard aliens are real. I did it as a joke. The people that are into the lizard aliens, people got mad at me. It's satire. I said it was satire. You can't take when I do satire and then say it's real.
Right.
Like, I don't really think you're Chris Hayes. You're not, you know, as good looking as she is. Let's go back to the tape. Here it is.
A worst internet TV show. This is for the skeptics out there who don't believe there really are alien lizard people out there who are moving among us, mostly invisible, secretly controlling American policy. In order to demonstrate their influence, they dress up as alien lizard people at InfoWars.com to show you the effect that the lizards are having on the United States government so you can recognize their work when they surface among us, even though most of us can't see them. Some of us can see them.
Let's hit pause. It's clearly satire. She knows that she doesn't play the audio of what I'm saying.
Of course not.
It's me in a lizard hat.
Making fun of Obamacare, I think is what you're
doing. Yeah, with a top hat on, making a joke.
Yeah.
Okay? And she knows that, but she thinks her viewers are idiots, which there aren't many of them left, but, you know, I guess they are. Or they tune in for comedy. Let's finish up with Matt O.
That's one side in what is supposed to be a contest between two equally feasible political choices to be the leader of the free world, commander-in-chief, and president of the United States.
How about make you the commander?
And what we're going to talk about tonight is if you are the other side, what do you do with that? Hey there, I'm Chris.
Hey there, it's Rachel Maddow. I mean, if you read every article, it's like, don't listen to them. You're not allowed to. It's kooky. We define the rules.
Yeah.
Don't you kooks get it? The con game's over, sweetheart. And I'm just here as a shock troop to run over you and overrun your machine gun bases. The big army's coming right behind me.
Yeah.
They haven't figured this out yet, have they, dude? Because they're all a bunch of self-centered little maggots.
And
I don't care what happens to me, dumbass.
There's people working in that organization, too, at MSNBC that are probably real patriots and let stuff out, like, you know, say the Reuters guy who went.
Well, we know they leaked that stuff.
Yeah. Or when in CNN, when they find the black guy, I think it was CNN, they find the black guy at the Trump rally, and he's like, I think we all got to come together. And they're like, well, obviously, not every black person there likes, well, God, what do we do? Somebody just said something normal. You know, we can't spin this. And it's just so funny watching them flounder. Issue after issue after issue.
Yeah, they're here to divide us.
Talk about her health.
They're here to do all this crap to us, and they just spin every side. I mean, it's like Trump always said, we're gonna make it easier if you've got a good record and you want a job to come here because we need workers in America. But if you're a felon like the guy in Austin that raped five women, was deported over and over again, and was caught raping again. I mean, he shouldn't get deported. Execute the son of a bitch after three rapes.
Yeah.
I mean, I got daughters here, man. We've had, quite frankly, people in this office have had folks connected to them raped recently. I mean, it's an epidemic in Austin.
Yeah.
They say it's all happening on campuses. When it really happens, they cover it up. I mean, at knife point, in parking lots.
Yeah.
And it's just like, what the hell? And it's not saying the average Mexican's like this, but the criminals that get in trouble in Mexico run up here. And then they, there was that railway serial killer, killed like 30-something people.
Yeah.
He'd been deported 6 or 7 times. They knew he was murdering people or letting him go. It's like Trump says, 2 million people of 30 million illegals are felons. And they go, he doesn't know that number. And actually, I went and looked up this morning. No, he does. That's what they admit in the last 3 years alone. They've released that are felons. It's 2 million. It's a conservative number. 2 million people. Why the hell, if you are from Latin America and you're a rapist or an armed robber, do you get let go? What planet are we on here?
It's a free pass. And Obama let out at least 100,000, it was over 100,000 prisoners out of jail. They just said, oh, and they were all illegals. And it was
once every few months.
They just, oh, we're just going to let them go.
But Rachel Maddow thinks it's all funny. And then she went on, I'm told, for the rest of the show attacking us.
Promoting us.
But the problem is, dude, listen, we noticed there was no extra sales this morning off this. There's no viewers, bro.
Yeah.
I've been on CNN, Fox, MSNBC over and over again to the point of when they call me now, I don't even go on it.
Right.
Because they just edit it. They always want to do it taped. And there's no effect. I go on some little Christian radio station as a guest, and I say I plug a film and I sell 200 copies.
Right.
And the point is as a measure of the of people out there, that's who cares. It's like talking to dead people. I don't go to the cemetery and give speeches.
Right.
And let me tell you, cemetery, it's time to rise up and fight the new order. No, they're dead. Christ said, let the dead bury the dead. I am not worried about these people. I only play this to illustrate it. But speaking of funding, the Mr. Maddow special is running huge discounts on nutraceuticals that they demonized and attacked at InfoWarsLife.com. Or call toll free, 888-253-3139. That's the Mr. Maddow special. Don't end up like Maddow. Make sure you get the X2 iodine you need for your glands to operate properly, or Global's chemical warfare will have you end up like the creature Maddow. The anti-Maddow special, available at InfoWarsLive.com. I'll be back this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. Central. But don't worry, a fourth hour straight ahead. Stay with us. That's what we have to do. You have to take our will. They can feel it. And just press it against the globalist. And not care what they do to us. You say, you know what? I'm going to lay on top of you no matter what you do. We're going to suffocate these people. Yeah. Hit his mic, guys.
And then they do it again. And you go, okay. And you go, and you just keep stepping forward one step at a time.
And they go, we can kill you. We're like, yeah, we know you already killed a lot of innocent people. You creep around and kill innocent people. You can get your hands on their disarmed, you son of a bitch.
Yep.
And thank God our forebears weren't like that. We've got weapons laid out against you. I know you're going to cover your flu news for 5 minutes in the next segment and hand the baton to David Knight. I'm going to hand it over to you here in 5 minutes. But I want to get to this. Well, tell us about our great auxiliary reporters there in Ohio, Millie Weaver and her great husband,
yep,
and what they've been doing with us. I'm very excited. I hope we get the funding to actually hire them full-time soon. But this is huge. This isn't just ambulances. Buried in the report is like 45 minutes in a tent and everything else happening, and stretchers being run around. This is big. I wish this would go viral.
Yeah, we put out a report, or Millie did, on Friday, which we put out. We put it out, and it got over 200,000 views about, you know, the ambulance coming in. And people attacked her and said, there's ambulances with every presidential motorcade, which there is, and a presidential motorcade. She ain't president yet. It's not normal. And Trump, at the same location in Cleveland, didn't have an ambulance.
But normally, well, of course, we miss the forest for the trees. It doesn't matter. She's in this medical tent. They're exactly running around like someone's dying.
She's got a periscope that's in that report. There's a link to her long periscope, which is live video. And she's shooting live video. She gets the gurney coming in. She's talking about, oh, what's that? Why is there a gurney here? Is there something going on? And it sits over here by this backstage area where she had just got done coughing, I guess, her hacking attack. And so she's sitting there forever and never comes out. And they're waiting for her and waiting for her and waiting for her. And finally, they scoot her out. I guess, I don't know if Millie got that on tape. I don't think she has that on tape of her scurrying away. But then the whole entourage leaves, you know, with the gurney. The gurney gets packed up.
If there was any independent media, we'd have exactly what happened. But there's just this blackout.
Right.
I'm concerned about Hillary. Dr. Drew fired.
Right.
Let's go to part of this clip. The full interview's on InfoWars.com. Here it is.
Hillary Clinton has a literal deathbed on wheels being rolled up to her tent to just catch her in case she drops dead at any minute.
Yeah, that's exactly what it
was. It was pretty crazy because I'm standing there waiting for Hillary to, you know, come out of her tent, and the event was already running over an hour behind. So I had a feeling that something was wrong, that maybe she was sick or having some type of an episode or something. And sure enough, I turn right around and there is a gurney, and there's, you know, these EMS workers, but they are wearing what looks like bulletproof vests. And, you know, I was like, is this for Hillary Clinton? And sure enough, it was the same EMS workers that my video camera guy actually caught. You know, those people, you know, the ambulance that was part of her motorcade, you know, those guys came out of there, and it seemed like they tried to wheel around as to, you know, not look too obvious going directly out of her tent or into her tent, but they were staged right behind stage.
Right.
Waiting in the event that maybe, you know, she might have had something happen, or maybe she fainted or fell, or, you know, we don't know what could have happened.
Or a change of diapers.
Or she had more, when I said postpartum depression, she was giving birth to more little alien life
forms. All right, well, bottom line is the globalists are attacking us at point-blank range because they know we've broken through. We're exposing what they're really doing. We're asking real questions. They can't stand it. Rob, you're going to come back and hit this big flu news. David Knight, we're going to break in 30 seconds, but tell us what else is coming up in the next hour as you host, my friend.
Alex, we're going to be taking a look at what Donald Trump did today. He was talking to the Family Research Council, and he called for getting rid of the Johnson Amendment. As you remember, we have talked to the Pulpit Freedom Sunday people before. That's the gag amendment on churches and violation of the First Amendment. Important statement he made today.
Trump is very excited about that. When I've talked to him on the phone, he always brings that up.
He said,
you know, I'm going to free the churches. Churches that have free speech. I'm like, okay, yeah, I know you're doing that. He just keeps, Trump's really into that, really into religious freedom. So we're going to be talking about that straight ahead. I'm going to punch out till this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. I'll be co-hosting with Paul Watson. But we'll come right back on the other side with Rob Due, David Knight.
In the fourth hour of Overdrive, this is Rob Due hosting. We've got David Knight standing by to take over. We're going to just put bookends on a couple things. Rachel Maddow was talking about how esteemed her group is on the left and with lies and stuff. And then over here on the fringe right where nobody goes, they're listening to Alex Jones, and then they take a bunch of stuff out of context. But here's an article out of the American Mirror. Only 20% of expected turnout for Hillary's speech to Baptist convention. Guys, get the shot of this. This is amazing. They actually close in. You could see a bunch of seats behind this area that they're closing off with walls. Can y'all get that on document cam? I mean, it is truly amazing right there. You can see sparsely populated all around here. Back here, that's nobody, and they're closing it in to make it look like it's bigger. So it's all about illusion that Hillary is a credible candidate at this point. Bernie Sanders could get more people out to a Baptist convention, and he's a Jewish guy. He could get more people to show up for him than Hillary Clinton could. And you could see, I actually went to a Bernie rally in Green Bay, Wisconsin, and I went to a Clinton rally. It was Bill Clinton even the day before. Maybe about 400 people at the most at this Bill Clinton thing, and that's giving him a lot of credit. Very small room, very small room. And then you go to a stadium, an indoor arena, about 1,200 people for Bernie Sanders, yet he magically, you know, gets beat in all these places. And then when they did the analysis and went the places with paper ballots, he actually would win, and then the places that had electronic voting, he would be losing by 20%. So it's just funny the way they do this. And, you know, of course, Hillary health concern is serious. Most doctors polled by the American Association of Physicians and Surgeons, 71% say her concerns are serious and she should be disqualified. But that's okay. We're kooks because we asked that type of information. Now I want to finish up with this other health news. This is why I came into Alex this morning, got this form right here. My wife actually threw away the first form that came with my second son. Goes to an elementary school. And it's the 2016-17 seasonal flu vaccine consent form. Please complete the entire form and sign. Incomplete forms will not be accepted. They want all this information. They want your insurance information. And then here, this is the juicy right here, guys. Look at that. Yes, I want to help protect my family and community from flu by allowing my child to receive a flu vaccine. That's the checkbox, yes. Now, no. David Knight, listen to this. No, I do not wish to help protect my family and community by allowing my child to participate. And then they want a reason. They want a reason why you don't want to participate. And then you got to sign it. And they put a little bit of information here on the back, which doesn't show that much. This is the insert you get from the doctor when they say, oh, here's the insert, when it's not. This is an actual flu vaccine insert. That's what it is. Okay. It's many pages long. And I've only got a few things highlighted in here. You should go through and read this. Here's another flu vaccine insert. Here's another one. Okay. This is what they look like. They're not a page. Okay. And if you care about your child, you should read an insert and see what's in it, because it has things like this. And I'll get your comment on this, David, as we go along. Oh, well, first talks about how, you know, they say a pregnant woman should get her flu shot. Here it says it's never been tested on reproductive systems, on reproductive health, or damaging a fetus, yet they tell pregnant women to get them. But they've never tested it on them. Oh, here's the multi-dose vaccine contains 12 micrograms of mercury. That's the 0.25 milliliter dose. The half milliliter dose from a multi-dose vaccine contains 25 micrograms of mercury. Oh, we don't tell you that. Here's my favorite right here. Carcinogenesis, mutagenesis, and impairment of fertility. It's never been evaluated for carcinogenic or mutagenic potential. A reproductive study of female rabbits vaccinated with fluzone is performed, and they have no evidence of impairment of fertility, but they've never tested to see if it causes cancer. And we know the polio vaccine had the SV40 virus in it, caused cancer in lots of people, and cancer rates are exploding, and yet they want your young child to get vaccinated with the flu shot. And if you don't, they want to know a reason why. So my wife threw away the first one, didn't tell me about it, because she goes, you're going to make a news story about it. And when she told me about this one this morning, I said, give me that damn paper. I'm doing a story on it today. Because this kind of stuff really pisses me off. The school should not be involved, even though we've already signed the forms that they tell you to sign to get your kid into school that says, we're opting out, bro. We don't want to be part of your medical paradigm, which is keeping kids sick. David Knight, your comments on that.
Well, you know, Rob, even the people who are vaccine advocates admit that the flu vaccine is not effective, okay? And what we're going to see is the way that they're applying this pressure point through school. We see this happening in California this year. Remember, it was this year, the school year, where people in California is like, you're not going to put a new kid in the California system, even private schools, okay, they ban it. You can't get your kids educated, sign them up for school, or go past the second grade or the seventh grade. I can't remember if it's 7 years old or the seventh grade. But anyway, they're putting this block in there unless you get vaccines.
Right.
And I put some stuff out on Twitter, when Gary Johnson was out there talking about, well, you know, I think that this is really something that ought to be decided locally, but, you know, maybe if it becomes a federal issue, I'd have to take a look at the science. And I said, you know what? Get your laws off my body, Gary. He loves to say that when it comes to abortion, but he won't say that when it comes to your kids, with you making those decisions about that. So I got trolled, predictably, by some vaccine supporter that's out there. He says, you're dangerous. And I said, yeah, you know, freedom is dangerous, but the slavery that you propose is far more dangerous.
Exactly. And David, you mentioned the effectiveness.
Dangerous. Yeah.
Well, let's go to this. This is from USA Today. Flu shot only 19% effective this winter. That was in 2015. Well, they've gone a little better. I will give them that. Now they're saying that only fails half the time. And that's it. That came out in April. They're saying it's only going to fail half the time. So give your kid a shot that even on the little insert, it says it could give you Guillain-Barré, but most people won't even look that up. Okay. Most of these people's parents are like, yeah, whatever, we'll sign and get your flu shot. And it still charges you for it. This is all run by a nonprofit, which is basically financed by these for-profit corporations that provide medical services to schools, you know, hearing tests and vision tests and stuff like that. But now they want to start providing vaccines. And now they say the flu mist doesn't even work. That came out. They're saying flu mist doesn't work. We're not even recommending it for kids. You got to get the shot because we got to get the aluminum and the mercury inside of you and all the other ingredients that when you start reading about, you're like, what the hell? I'm not going to put this in my kid.
Yeah. You know, Rob, you mentioned the mercury and, of course, thimerosal. I'll give you a personal example. Decades ago, when I started to get contact lenses, I would put the solution in my eyes and they would immediately turn blood red and start burning. Okay. So I stopped using contacts altogether. And then I guess it's about 10 years ago, I had a doctor say, you know, why don't you try contacts? And I said, well, I can, but I'm allergic to the thimerosal. That's what we worked out. And he goes, oh, they don't even allow that anymore. You know, that's mercury. It's like, oh, okay. So they were selling eye drops.
Put mercury in your eyes.
But they put the thimerosal in the vaccines now because you can't see what it's doing to your body like you can when you drop it in your eyes.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. Exactly. And that's how they hide it. And yeah. It's amazing that people are going to sign their kids up for this. And there's probably going to be an outbreak of flu at the school. I'll be watching Sunset Valley Elementary, by the way. I'll just let you guys know where it is. But that it's crazy that they're sending this home and then we didn't even fill it out and send it back because I don't want to be a part of their, you know, little who knows what they're doing with all this data, too. Who your insurance company is, your policyholder's name, the member ID, you know, who knows what they could do with all this information. But they want that so they can go and charge your insurance company.
But are they going to imply that that is your consent if you don't give them that form? I mean, is that the default position?
You know, because it says they won't do anything unless it's an incomplete form. Well, they say incomplete forms will not be accepted.
Okay.
But I've told my kid, under no circumstances are you to go anywhere where they're jabbing anything into anybody.
Run for your life.
Exactly. And I say, I will give you lots of cookies if you do that.
You know, Rob, last night we went to see a movie, Florence Foster Jenkins. Okay, it's really funny. It's a Meryl Streep thing about True Life story. Anyway, this woman who was perhaps one of the funniest, worst singers ever. There's been a lot of movies about her. Died in 1944. She was suffering from syphilis. The way they treated it was with arsenic and mercury. And when they mentioned that, it's like people in the audience are like, oh, my, you know, but that's what we have. That was 1944. And we're going to look back in future years at the pharmaceuticals that people are giving us, and we're going to say the same thing about that.
Oh, exactly.
And I've got an article I'm going to cover later in the hour. Addictive painkiller profiteers donating $500,000 to fight cannabis legalization in Arizona. So you've got a big pharmaceutical company that has a very dangerous drug. They've been sued by the attorney general in Illinois, and yet they're spending $500,000 to try to fight medical marijuana in Arizona. That's the true story that we see being repeated over and over across this country.
And David, you're talking about 1940s technology, what they were using for medical care back then. Dr. Drew was saying the same thing about Hillary. He said, I'm looking at these medications. This is from the 1940s. They don't even use this anymore because it could cause all these other side effects.
Yeah.
He goes, "Who?" You know, it's like her family doctor that she met when she was a child is still giving her health advice. I mean, you would think, you know, somebody running for president would be getting better health advice. And that's what he was concerned about. And he's a mainstream guy. He's not, you know, he toes the line when it comes to this stuff. But obviously he didn't toe the line this time. So now his show's being canceled. But it has nothing to do with what he said about Hillary. That's what they want you to believe.
Well, maybe she's been on it for a very long time, Rob.
Oh, I'm sure she has. Yeah. I mean, you know, you can't make those goofy faces, or I don't see how she could even talk with two giant vessels, whatever she had in her mouth.
Oh, that was disgusting.
Lots of speculation there. But how she lots has those in, and then she quickly ejects them out, and then takes a drink.
Lots of expectoration there.
Yeah. God, you got to love the people who are examining this footage and looking at it and going, what the hell? I've got to put this out to people. You know, the guy who saw the reflection in her ear that looks like it could be an earpiece. And then we're showing the photos that they're showing on MSNBC, and one of them looks completely doctored. Completely. You can see the jagged edges around the ear, like on the inside. Not, you know, on the outside of a person, you can see some a little bit.
Yeah.
But there in the inside of the ear, it's everywhere. It's like, whoa, obviously, Photoshop.
I'm sure she didn't spit anything in those glasses either.
Oh, yeah, exactly.
We're making stuff up.
David Knight's coming up.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, your host on this Friday. We've got a lot of news we're going to talk about. We're going to continue with the medical news that I was just mentioned to Rob Dew. We're also going to talk about Trump's repeal of the Johnson Amendment. If you don't know what that is, we're going to tell you briefly what the history of that is, what Donald Trump said today to the Family Research Council. It's interesting, you know, because we had Rob Dew showing the pictures of the meeting where Hillary is talking to Baptists. They couldn't even fill one-fifth of the place, even after they brought the walls forward. And if you look at that picture, it's even worse than that. It's mostly empty. There's only about a fifth of the seats filled. And if you look at the seats that are filled, there's a lot of people sitting there in white robes. I mean, she is literally preaching to the choir, folks. That's how bad it is. And nobody else is showing up at these events. But it is an important free speech First Amendment issue. We're also going to talk about how Obama now has a Saudi dilemma, thanks to Donald Trump. The House has unanimously passed a bill to allow 9/11 lawsuits. I'm going to break that down as to why I think Trump had a lot to do with it. We'll take a little bit of credit for that here at InfoWars as well. We're going to talk about what's going on with the pipeline out west in Dakota. And we've got a lot of news that we want to talk about. But first, you know, when Alex was playing Rachel Maddow, making fun of our products and saying, you know, don't swallow that toothpaste, that fluoride in that toothpaste. That's really bad stuff. You know, John Bowne actually did a report on that. Reading the warning label that's on the back, you know, Rob was just talking about the inserts in your vaccines. Read what is on the back of the toothpaste. It says, hey, if your kids swallow this, call the emergency services and get something done about this. Now, why is it that they have to warn you about the fluoride in the toothpaste, but they put it in our water? And look at the Harvard studies. Has she ever heard of Harvard? You know, it's a venerated liberal Northeastern establishment. Maybe you ought to see what they have to say about excessive fluoride and the effects that it has on your IQ, especially children's IQ. So we have a lot of specials up. We have 30 to 40% off InfoWars Select storable food. Far be it from us to tell you that you need food to survive and a way that you can get a good, clean source of it at a discount, 30 to 40% off, that you can store for emergencies. I mean, you know, how paranoid is that? Think that you're going to have a flood or a hurricane or a tornado or something even larger that could take down the grid for a while. But, you know, you don't need to have any food, even for a week. You know, just rely on the just-in-time delivery of Walmart. That's what you should do. You know, don't buy our clean, select, storable foods, okay? Just depend on Walmart. They'll be there for you. Rachel Maddow promises that. So we got 30, 40% off InfoWars Select, in case you don't believe Rachel. We've also got 20% off Survival Shield X2 Nascent Iodine. Want to make sure that you've got some iodine? Oh, that's paranoid, but you might want to look into that. Well, you might want to have that air filter. You wouldn't want to have clean air, would you? That's paranoid. 20% off the Alexa Pure air filters, and we've got another conspiracy theory for you. You should think about making sure your water is clean and pure. You know, for health reasons. That's just a conspiracy theory we're putting forward here. But if you buy into that conspiracy theory about clean water, we got 20% off Alexa Pure water filters. Again, InfoWarsStore.com. We have massive sales, up to 40% off our preparedness products there. That it will be ending soon. But we have a new special where we are featuring products that Mr. Rachel Maddow promoted on MSNBC. We've got Survival Shield Nascent Iodine, as I just mentioned, 20% off, but we've added 15% off Super Male Vitality, 15% off Deep Cleanse, just in honor of Mr. Maddow. All right, let's talk about what's happening out in Arizona. Headline from RT, addictive painkiller profiteer donates $500,000 to fight cannabis legalization in Arizona. This is Insys Therapeutics. Their product is the drug name Subsist. It is a sublingual fentanyl spray, okay? And if you don't know why that is what Prince died of an overdose of. It's what one-third of Ohio's 3,000 deaths caused by lethal drug consumption last year were linked to that drug. It is the only product that corporation that is fighting medical marijuana produces. Wouldn't be because it is a competitor to them, would it? A John Hopkins University, you know those conspiracy theorists at John Hopkins? They did a study back in 2014. They found that legalized marijuana had, states that had it, had 25% less overdose deaths from prescription drugs than in states where it remained legal, okay? And as I pointed out, this is the only product this company sells. Last month, Illinois Attorney General brought a lawsuit against this company, claiming that they had deceptively marketed and sold their medication to doctors for uses other than cancer treatment, which is the only thing the FDA has approved as sole use for. She also said the company has a desire for increased profits that has led it to disregard patients' health and to push addicted opioids for non-FDA-approved purposes. But don't take medical marijuana, because that's far more dangerous, they tell you. That is the naked self-interest. That is how the FDA and the DEA have had regulatory capture by these pharmaceutical companies. That's why they're keeping the stuff off the market. Stay with us. We got more news. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight. This segment, I want to talk a little bit about money and politics and the political horrors that are seeking it. And I'm looking at you, Gary Johnson. Let's talk about that. First of all, RT and Drudge pointed this. Move over, Koch brothers. Facebook co-founder pledges $20 million to the Democrats. And, of course, Koch brothers are the favorite whipping boy of the left. Although, they have contributed to the Clintons in the past, and they absolutely hate Donald Trump. But now we've got $20 million from a Facebook co-founder going to Hillary Clinton. And remember back when they had the nominating convention for the LP, I remember them literally prostituting themselves on C-SPAN. We got the guy, the fat man, who was stripping down to the G-string, which was unbelievable. I guess that's a first for a C-SPAN. But at the same time, perhaps even worse, I would say definitely worse, we had the Libertarian Party itself talking about how they were going to get all of this money from the Koch brothers. And the Koch brothers said, no, you're not. Pull it back. I don't know if they're giving them money or not. Somebody's giving them a lot of money. They're running a lot of ads, a lot of very effective ads, which don't really talk about their positions. Don't really talk about the things that are unique about Gary Johnson as a Libertarian candidate, opposing things like the Second Amendment, talking about how he is obliquely for mandatory vaccines. If he pushes back on that somewhat, the man said, if it becomes a federal issue, I'll have to defer to the scientists. It's like, you have absolutely no concept of individual liberty if you say that. Even if he says, I think it's a local issue. It's not a local issue, Gary. Stop being a collectivist statist. It's not a local issue. It's an individual rights issue. You should stand up for that. You should be as indignant 4 years ago when the TSA was demanding papers from Americans at the airport as you are about people demanding papers from people here illegally. Okay, but let's look at what just recently happened. There was a great parody video that went up on the Daily Beast about Gary Johnson, the Aleppo incident. I want to play a little bit of this because it's very funny. And then I'm going to go over the fact that, you know, he said that he thought initially as an excuse, he said, I thought that Aleppo was an acronym. So I actually put it out on my Twitter account. I said, okay, an acronym. Maybe you guys can come up with some funny acronyms, and they did. So I'm going to read you some of the acronyms for Aleppo that came up with some of the people on my Twitter account. But let's play this video. This is Gary Johnson playing Jeopardy.
Its biggest university is Boise State.
What is Aleppo?
No. Cue the deer and antelope. This is Kansas's state song.
What is Aleppo?
No. A Liberian warlord known as General Butt Naked inspired an antagonist in this recent musical about missionaries in Africa.
Aleppo.
You are wrong.
Kina. Okay. All right. Get the idea. It's a very funny video. It's done by the Daily Beast. You can watch the full thing at their site. What is Aleppo? Okay. He didn't know what that was. And interestingly enough, you know, Aleppo, the largest city in Syria, the commercial center of Syria, was also the site of the Battle of Aleppo, which began, I believe it was the summer, I think it was in July of 2012, when Gary Johnson was running for president 4 years ago. He couldn't be bothered. He didn't want to know what the sources of that war were. And, you know, if you're going to be completely ignorant about where things come from, like 9/11, you're not going to have a very effective opposition to it. If you don't really understand what happened in Benghazi, in Libya, and the prelude to Syria, who was behind that? The fact that we were starting that war, that we were funding and training ISIS, you're not going to have a very effective solution to it. You're going to fall for all kinds of politically correct nonsense, like saying, we need to bring the refugees here. No, we need to bring peace to the area by stopping what we have done to start that. That's the real issue. And I understand that a lot of people would say, well, it's kind of a gotcha moment. It actually was something that was talked about quite a bit. I mean, we just had a lot of people putting up that horrific poster, that child, the Aleppo boy. I mean, it was in the news quite a bit. And I understand to some degree, libertarians just don't want to get involved in the rest of the world, okay? But he's not articulating that clearly. And he is selling a politically correct solution for the globalists. And he doesn't understand the consequences of that either. He doesn't understand where the open borders refugee movement comes from either. He doesn't understand the origins of the Syrian conflict. He doesn't understand how Hillary Clinton set the Middle East on fire. He and William Weld have praised her as a statesperson, okay? They don't understand anything that is happening. Absolutely, totally clueless as to the origins of that. But I want to talk in a moment before I want to spend a little bit more time on this. You know, Clinton was pretty clueless about Iraq, about Mosul as well. But before we do, you know, Gary Johnson said, hey, as an excuse, I really at first I thought Aleppo was acronym. So I asked people on Twitter, I said, give me some acronyms of what Aleppo might really stand for. Here's some of them. Awkward lunatic espouses piss poor opinions. Well, that's a pretty good one. AstroTurf libertarian exhibiting particularly painful obliviousness. Yep. Alleviating latent email problems post-op. A loser envisioning pseudo-presidential opportunities. Aleppo, the acronym. A libertarian embarrassed political... A libertarian embarrassed. Political prospects over. Another one. Also, low energy. Please pull out. And on and on. And so we've got one person here who says, hey, Gary Johnson thought Aleppo was the fifth member of the Marx Brothers. You know, the guy with the fuzzy hair? The guy says, he thought the interviewer said Geppetto, which is why he snapped back so quickly. Because you know what? He's just a puppet. A puppet of the globalists. But what about Hillary? You know, on the speech, the forum that they were given the other night, which really was a couple of speeches, although Donald Trump took a lot of questions, and I thought he engaged very well. But Hillary came out and said, you know, we're not ever going to have any ground troops in Iraq ever. And she's now being tagged on this by the Washington Post, by ABC. I mean, the Washington Post, I mean, these people are basically paid campaign consultants for Hillary Clinton. Even they are having a problem with this. Here's what ABC said. Said Hillary Clinton on Wednesday said she wouldn't put ground troops in Iraq ever again. And she would never use boots on the ground to defeat ISIS. And I want people to think about this as we're looking at this. You know, there are boots on the ground is what they pointed out. Okay. We actually do have troops on the ground. And we are putting more troops on the ground. This headline from Wall Street Journal. U.S. gets ready to assist offensive to retake key Iraqi city from Islamic State. Now, the Washington Post says they'd like to mince the words. They like to play semantics. They like to say, well, we don't have soldiers there. We've got advisors and we've got air support. Yeah, 4,000 plus advisors. At some point, you got to say that it's more than advisors. And you also have to wonder, as they build up in this offensive, as American soldiers go into combat, is Hillary Clinton going to be so concerned about optics? Because that's what she was stressing the other night in the Commander-in-Chief Forum Wednesday night. She was saying, we're not ever going to put boots on the ground again. We have to defeat ISIS. We've got to do it with air power. And then she talks about they. The Iraqis, they've taken back Ramadi, Fallujah. They've got to hold them. They've got to get into Mosul now. Okay, it's going to be these other people. We don't want to see Americans there. Do you understand? That was a key part of what was involved when she left those people in Benghazi stranded to die for 13 hours. She didn't want the optics of having more American soldiers gone. Remember, they changed uniforms multiple times, clothes multiple times. I don't know, you know, would it be appropriate? Should they dress as soldiers? You know, maybe we should have them dress as circus clowns or something so we don't offend people. They kept changing their clothes. They delayed it. They didn't want to send very many people there because of the optics of all of this, okay? This is what she's talking about. The woman cannot be trusted to be a commander-in-chief, okay? You cannot defeat ISIS by hurling microaggressions at them. And she's not even willing to do that. She takes these people who support Sharia law and she has them introduce her on the podium as she's accepting the nomination for president. That's what Sharia Khan did, okay? This is a guy who has spent most of his, he's a Sharia lawyer, okay? He gets people in this country, but he has written commentaries on Sharia law, which is the antithesis of what our Constitution is about, what our soldiers fight for. And yet she has that man introduce her, hold him forth as a Gold Star family. And as Joe Biggs has mentioned many times, you're going to say that Donald Trump, when he fights back against this Sharia-pushing lawyer who attacked him, you're going to say he's disrespecting Gold Star families. What about the Gold Star families that Hillary Clinton disrespected associated with Benghazi? Leaving their families to die for optics. And then lying to them repeatedly as she lied to the American public over Benghazi. Now, the Washington Post goes on talking about the situation in Mosul and Iraq. They say she's got two big problems with this no ground troops pledge. Okay, they say it's been a very uncomfortable subject for Hillary Clinton for a long time, the Iraq war. Her vote to authorize the war alienated progressives against her. And now what she tries to do is to say, well, you know, Donald Trump was for the war before he was against it. There's a big difference between an offhand remark that he made when he was asked about this on the radio by Howard Stern. He goes, well, you know, we never did finish, didn't do it right the first time. Maybe they should go back. And then he looks at it more carefully and says, you know, that's wrong. And he made a very strong statement for a very long time about that. She, however, was a U.S. senator with information, with a decision to make. It was her decision to make as to whether they should go in, she and the other senators. She needed to do the research on it. She didn't bother to do the research on it. And she was the one responsible. She had the vote and the responsibility to know what she was voting for. So she goes on and says, well, they're not going to get ground troops. They're not going to put ground troops in Iraq ever again. And the Washington Post points out she said it four times. Clearly, they said, this was a message that she intended to deliver. And then she again elaborated it yesterday on the news conference on Thursday following what she'd said on Wednesday night's Commander-in-Chief Forum. She doubled down on it. And they say, well, the first problem is that there are already ground troops in Iraq and Syria. The second is that in recent months, generals have asked for even more. Maybe she doesn't respect the judgment of generals who are commanding the troops under the Obama administration. And if we need to do something differently, why doesn't Obama do it now, people should ask, okay? If things need to be changed, why wait until Hillary becomes president? Anyway, they go on to say, the administration stresses that these troops are training Iraqis and serving in advisory capacities, not combat troops. But the Washington Post points out they are on the ground. And let me ask you, if you really believe that they're simply in advisory positions. This is military.com yesterday. 450 more troops arrive in Iraq to back a Mosul drive. They say that Air Force Colonel John Dorian declined to give a time frame for the start of the offensive, but he said, we're going to have to get started soon if Mosul will be wrested from the Islamic State of Iraq and Syria by the end of this year. Army Lieutenant General Townsend, task force commander, appeared to suggest in a Wall Street Journal interview that the Mosul offensive could begin as early as next month, okay? This is 400 additional troops to boost the total number of U.S. troops in Iraq from 4,000 to 4,450. Do we have that many advisors? 4,000 troops? It's roughly the number of ISIS troops that are in Mosul. So I don't think that they are simply advisors. Now, one of the things that Donald Trump is criticized for, and I've criticized him myself for this, is not being focused enough on civil liberties. Today, he focused on civil liberties. He focused on a very important civil liberty that has been violated for quite some time, and that is the First Amendment. The First Amendment talks about two things, doesn't it? It talks about freedom of political speech, and it talks about the free exercise of religion. Not that you can hold a belief, but that you have the right to exercise that belief. Actually, do your religion. You don't have to do it in a closet, folks. You can actually exercise that religion. And so, isn't it interesting that when the First Amendment has these two components, religious liberty and free speech, that we would have the IRS, under the direction and the amendment that was put in by Lyndon Johnson, try to divide those two from each other? You can't. You can't divide those two. And if you know history, you know that an important part of the American Revolution was the Black Robe Regiment, okay? The clergy who talked to people about what was going on. They understood what had happened in England. They had been the subject of religious persecution. America was largely founded by people who came to this country because they wanted religious liberty. That's why it's the First Amendment we have of the individual Bill of Rights in the Constitution. And where did this all come from? How did we get to a situation where churches have a gag order on them? And we've talked about this many times. They rope-a-dope you in with your subsidy, with your tax deductions. They say, if you organize yourself as a corporation, as a 501c corporation, churches, we will give you tax benefits. And then they will use those strings attached to the tax benefits to gag you from political speech. That's the way this has worked out. And most churches are organized like that. They're very concerned they're going to lose that tax deduction, that it would go back and all the people who had donated money to the church would get audited. So they organize themselves as a corporation in obedience to the IRS rather than standing up to them. There are some brave individuals and a brave organization that has stood up to them. They've organized Pulpit Freedom Sunday. They do that every year. And it began as just a handful of people who recorded their political, expressly political speeches in the pulpit, recorded those, sent it to the IRS, and said, do something about it if you have the authority. That is key, folks. And I'm telling you that if we get our freedoms back, it's going to be led by the Black Robe Regiment again. They have the guts on these people who are exercising Pulpit Freedom Sunday, and it's now spread to several hundred who have done this over the last couple of years. And guess what? The IRS hasn't done anything. You had the lesbian mayor of Houston try to shut down churches when they started pushing some of this transgender stuff with bathrooms and other issues in Houston, and demanding that they send their sermons to her to be looked at. And they've refused. We're not going to do it. You don't have to submit to tyranny. And wouldn't it be great if we had church leaders, if we had pastors, if we had people who would stand up and call this bluff? I don't care where it comes from. It'd be great if the churches would do this for the people who are in their flock. So New American talks about this, and they said on Friday, Family Research Council's convention in Washington, D.C., Donald Trump is expected to reiterate his call to repeal the Lyndon Johnson Amendment, in line with a similar call in the GOP platform. His speech will say, you have so much to contribute to our politics, yet our laws prevent you from speaking your minds from your own pulpits. An amendment pushed by Lyndon Johnson many years ago threatens religious institutions with a loss of their tax-exempt status if they openly advocate their political views. Trump said, I am going to work very hard to repeal that language to protect free speech for all Americans. And where did this come from? This came from Lyndon Johnson. Why? He wanted to punish churches who had talked about his shady background. So when he won the election, he did this as punishment to churches, and most churches have abided by that gag order all of this time. Yet Donald Trump is going to stand up against that, stand up for the First Amendment. How about that? Isn't that interesting? Standing up for civil liberties in a way that Gary Johnson, the libertarian, won't. Welcome back to our last segment of the fourth hour. I'm David Knight here on the Alex Jones Radio Show, and we're going to talk about another effect from Trump, and that is the bill that has been unanimously passed today in the House that will allow 9/11 families to do lawsuits against Saudi Arabia. And of course, the Democrats hate it. The Republicans hate it at the top. This is something that now has widespread support, however. Why did that happen? How did that happen all of a sudden? And, of course, they're saying, well, you know, Obama is in a dilemma now with the Saudis. He is very concerned about this, and he has threatened to veto this. He said there's absolutely no way, said White House spokesman Josh Earnest, that I could envision President Obama signing this bill. Nevertheless, the pushback now has grown so large, they don't think that he's going to be able to override his veto if he does decide to veto it. It'd be the first time that has happened. How did it get to that point? You remember, nobody was talking about this until Trump started talking about the missing 28 pages. That turned things around. There have been huge changes right now in the body politic, even without Donald Trump being elected president. And I think very positive changes that have been happening here with this. These are people like John Bolton, former UN ambassador, who are complaining about this, a Bush official, as well as Obama, who put the well-being of the Saudis ahead of that of the 9/11 families. We have a right to know what happened, and we have a right for those families to be compensated for what they allowed to happen. What they allowed to happen. You have to understand that. And we can thank Donald Trump for making this an issue and for turning around public opinion to the extent that even the united leadership of the two mainstream parties cannot stop it. Now, real quickly, I've got some other news I want to talk about with George Soros' Open Foundation supporting online voting. Before I do, real quickly, I want to let you know that we have a Mr. Rachel Maddow special that we've put up in honor of him or her talking about how we finance our operation. You know why we sell our own products like this? Because we don't want to sell you something that we don't believe in. Alex very carefully vets these products. He puts out stuff that we're proud to sell. It supports our operation. It's an honest thing that we do here. We're not taking money from the government like MSNBC. We're not pushing pharmaceuticals that harm people like most of the major networks do. We are selling products like air filters and water filters. You know those conspiracies that you need clean air, clean water? We've got 20% off of those at InfoWarsStore.com. And we have the Mr. Rachel Maddow special in his or her honor. 20% off Survival Shield X2 Nascent Iodine, 15% off Super Male Vitality, 15% off Deep Cleanse. And, of course, the other preparedness special that we have is 30 to 40% off select storable food. You don't need good food either, according to Rachel Maddow, I guess. But we do sell that, and it will last made in the USA, no GMOs, no preservatives, but it will still last for 25 years. Again, 30 to 40% off of that, many other preparedness specials you'll find at InfoWarsStore.com. That will be ending soon, although we'll extend that Rachel Maddow sale for a while. Now, real quickly, at the top of Drudge today, an article exposing how the George Soros Foundation is seeking to expand online voting. Understand the many different ways that the Democrats have tried in the past to rig voting. Early voting, no voter ID, et cetera, et cetera. But key amongst all these is going to be online voting. At the very time we've got all of this information, everybody should be concerned about the security of things online, and yet what they want to do is make it easier to manipulate, to hack this for their benefit. And of course, the Breitbart article draws together the connections between the George Soros Open Society Foundation talking about how they're going to support Obama's executive orders and how they're going to create another power base by creating online voting. We've seen it all before. We've seen Smartmatic, the company that Lord Moloch Brown, how's that for a name? Lord Moloch Brown from the Open Society with George Soros pushing for crooked voting. Join us tonight for the InfoWars Nightly News, 7 Central, 8 p.m. Eastern. We're also going to talk about the Dakota Pipeline Flashpoint.